scoreboard game where John Rotts of the NFC for most of the season. The explosive offense was complemented by a begrudging defense as the Skins performed with an air of invincibility. But recently the brashness has faded. Defeat brought them down to earth as the division title slipped away. With spirits down, the normally sedate Joe Gibbs sounded the alarm last week. And his message was well taken as the Skins rallied and entered today's game with renewed confidence.
Good day to play.
Good afternoon. I'm Pat Summerall. With me, of course, as usual, analyst, former Oakland Raider, championship coach John Madden. And John, I think if you talk about today's game, Eric Dickerson perhaps said it best when he talked about the Ram philosophy last week. He said we were too finesseful. I'm not sure that's a word, but I think I know what he means.
Well, of course, and that's the thing that John Robinson said, we have to get out of that. You know, after the 49er game, John Robinson got very upset, and he said, this isn't Ram football. Maybe it's because of our new quarterback, Jim Everett. Maybe we're trying to do too many fancy things. He said, we have to go back to the physical thing. They did that. They hadn't been practicing in pads. Last week, they practiced Tuesday and Wednesday in pads, said they had their two best practices of the year, the most physical practices of the year, and they have to carry that over to today.
And you know, as we talk to Joe Gibbs, the Redskins, we're going to get a look at the Rams on offense first, as Steve Cox will kick off for the Redskins. Back deep for the Rams, Mickey Sutton and Charles White. This series, the Skins have won four straight. They won the last meeting 51-7 right here in the playoffs in 1983. Cox set to go. RFK Stadium sold out for the 158th consecutive time. It is going to be Charles White at the 2-yard line. White out of the pack with room. Get down at about the 26. Todd Bowles on the stop. That's Jim Everett, the Ram quarterback. 6'5 and 212. And here's the defense he'll be facing. Four-man in front. Mann and Manley, the ends, Butts and Grant, the two tackles. Back of them, the linebacker. Daniels, Olkowitz in the middle, and Rich Malott on the other side. And in the secondary, Green and Morris in the corners, Alvin Walton and Curtis Jordan. Two hitters. Terry Orr shaken up on the kickoff. He's number 87. And the Redskins throughout the year have had problems at that position.
Well, Terry Orr, of course, had been starting in Clint Didier's place when Didier broke his hand.
And it looks like Orr might have a problem with his hand. Young Jim Everett. And John Robinson, the Ram coach, says, hey, we've got something here with this guy. Dickerson and Redden, the two runners. House is the move man. Redden on first down, maybe a yard. Charles Mann, the first man to hit him. The offense, Everett the quarterback. Dickerson and Redden, the runners. Kevin House and Henry Ellard, the wide receivers. Up front, Hanky Newberry, Doug Smith, Dennis Hara, Jackie Slater, and David Hill, the tight end, second and nine. Pro Bowlers in that offensive line. House, wide left. Ellard, wide right. Dickerson deep. Eric Dickerson hammers out close to a first down. A gain of 80. Might be a little bit short. Monty Coleman brought him down.
Well, that's the first of his carries right there. The Rams were saying yesterday that they would like to run Dickerson about 30 times. And they'd like to run Barry Redden about 15 more times. That's a whole lot of running, 45.
But that's when they're their most effective.
I think, you know, to do that, as we said earlier, though, they have to get ahead.
Third and one. Dickerson gets the one and more. A gain of three. He's out to the 40. Todd Bowles made the stop. Terry Orr heading for x-rays in the Redskin locker room. It seemed to be a problem with his hand. First down Rams. They're at their own 40. Opening minutes, opening drive. Wild card playoff game between these two. Wide left. That's Redden who lines up on the flank to the left. And now now he moves in motion. Everett quickly ridden. Chased and covered by a linebacker, but not very effectively, as Curtis Jordan finally knocked him out of bounds after a gain of 19.
That was Okowitz trying to get out there to get to him. Here's what Everett was getting from the backside. We see Manley getting by Pankey there. Pankey grabbing him. He just gave Everett a little tap at the end. He's going to help pick him up so the official doesn't throw one of those flags on him.
Looks like he got Jim Everett for Christmas. Handled him like a rag doll.
But Everett got the first down.
And the Rams are in Redskin territory. First and 10 at the Redskin 40. Dickerson. Fumble. The Redskins come out of the pack with it. That's Alvin Walton. Still with it. And quickly back into Ram territory. Newberry tripped him up. But the Redskins get that first turnover.
The ball around there. They were going pretty good. Pretty good blocking here. Dickerson has the cutback, but he hit his own guy. He hit his left guard. It was Tom Newberry. It looked like his left arm hit Newberry, and the ball just hopped out of there. It wasn't a Redskin defender.
Harry Clark split wide to the left, and Art Monk out to the right. We'll set the rest of the Redskin offense in just a second. Schrader is the quarterback. Rogers gets the carry, and Rogers hammers. Rogers going. And he gets down inside the 30. Leroy Irvin finally tripped him up after a gain of 15.
I'll tell you, he's going to get a great block here from Donnie Warren. Watch 85 coming across in motion. Watch that trap right there. He knocked it down. He gave the big hole in there. The guy he blocked was a nose tackle, Sean Miller. But that was a block. I mean, ooh. Donnie Warren came across there and delivered a load on Miller.
And Sean Miller never saw him coming. You're right, John. What a tremendous block. Here comes Donnie Warren in motion. Fumble. Schrader on the exchange from his offensive center, Bostic. And they have to down it right there. Boy, things happening in a hurry.
See what happens here. It's just as he was pulling it out, it looked like he just pulled it out and just brought it right back beyond him. I'll tell you, you know, they always talk about intensity in playoffs, and whatever that word is, the level's up about three notches.
We've got it here. Second and 12. Didier is the man on the move. Schrader took his time and gets it to Didier. A gain of about five. There. That's one of the things that John Robinson was saying to us yesterday. Give him those short passes, but don't let him get turned upfield with it.
Well, he doesn't think that Jay Schrader can sit back there all day and look at those deep zones that they're going to play and keep his patience and throughout the whole game continue to hit the short guy.
It'll be third and eight. Sanders wide left. Kelvin Bryant in the game in place of Rogers. That's Monk.
Telephone to John Robinson on that one. He said yesterday, he said, if you have a phone to me, I can tell you if we're doing well. He said, when we play our zones, he said, if they catch a ball at 5 yards and we tackle them at five, then we're playing well. He said, if they catch it at five and run another five for first downs, as we're seeing Art Monk do, we're not playing well.
And he said, we're in trouble if that happens. And right now, it would appear they are in trouble. Redskin first down. They're at the Rams 16. No score yet. Schrader. A lot of time. It's going to be out of the end zone and no one there except our sign.
And Jerry Gray chasing it. The Rams cornerback. Hey, you talked about the players that the Rams have in the Pro Bowl on offense, but they also have their two corners. This guy, Jerry Gray here, and the other corner, Leroy Irvin. And I'll tell you, that's a different thing. When you get two cornerbacks that play all zone defense, that's an amazing thing. There's all the Rams that are in the Pro Bowl, but usually the cornerbacks that make the Pro Bowl are usually man-to-man cover guys.
In this case, they're zone covers, but an aggressive zone bunch. Schrader back at his own 25, down the middle of the mark. Ball is loose. They're going to say it was down. I'm sure Jerry Gray in the middle of that pack. Donnie Warren came up with it. Gain of 7.
The old Donnie Warren there, he's a tight end who doesn't get the ball much, has to recover fumbles and stuff, but he sure made a block that started this thing off. Here's what happens here at the end of the play. You see Monk has the ball. The Rams are trying to get it out. It goes out just as he goes down, and it's rolling around here. I think the whistle blew then.
That was Mark Giroux, who was bringing Monk down. It's 3rd and 3, and Rodgers back, and they give to Rodgers. He is hit, and that'll be short of the first down by a couple of yards. Nolan Cromwell came up to make the stop after a gain of 1 with the help from Mel Owens. And Jess Atkinson comes on. Kicked 3 extra points last week against the Eagles, but he hasn't kicked a field goal in a long, long time. How about a year and a half, almost?
Against these Redskins.
Right.
He was saying last week he kicked 3 extra points, and the guys were patting him on the back and stuff. He said, don't pat me for those. Wait until I get a field goal. Well,
this
here it is.
From 25 with Schrader holding. Very confident, and look at John Robinson congratulating the defensive unit. 8:59 left first quarter. Washington 3-0.
Fire Brewing. It's more than a way to make Strohs and Stroh Light. It's a family tradition passed down from one generation to another for over 200 years. It's what guarantees that smooth, consistent taste for generations to come.
Now you're talking Strohs. Now you're talking beer. Now you're talking good times. And Strohs is spoken here.
Razor-sharp perfection. We're looking for a few good men with a medal to be Marines.
The NFC's version of the wild card game, and the Redskins have broken on top. They lead 3-0. Steve Cox lining up and placing it down to kick it off to Mickey Sutton and Charles White. If he hits it, however, as strong as he is, if he hits it, it'll be in the stands back there. Got a great leg. Didn't hit it. Out of bounds, and they'll redo the whole thing.
It looked like he shanked it, didn't it? It looked like one of those things there. You're talking about a shank. I'll tell you, on that field goal of Jess Atkinson, Jay Schrader made a good play of getting that ball up. Because watch this again. The snap is low. And he puts it down. You see, it hits the ground before. He picks it up on the short hop, gets the laces turned around, and the perfect hole for Atkinson. That was a heck of a play by Schrader.
Short hop?
Well, that's what you get from your baseball days.
Right.
You know? Of course, before Jay Schrader played with the Redskins, he played 3 years of professional baseball.
Steve Cox now will tee it up back at the 30, and the Ram receivers Sutton and White move up. George Rogers, who had that big 15-yard run already and gained over 1,000 yards this year, having his thumb taped up.
You always go into those stats. If this guy gains over 100 yards, you always win or whatever. It's true of both of these running backs.
Rogers and Dickerson. Good high kick by Cox. Fielded at the 6 by Charles White. Jumps over one man. Gets just outside the 20. On Bowles again as the first man down with a lot of help from a lot of friends.
Well, he had Dean Hamill down there. The Redskins are one of the few guys, see him number 78, to use a big 280-pound guy running down. But watch him break the wedge. Watch here. He's a wedge buster. He just puts the wedge back going the other way. Then that lets other guys get in there.
He hit Mike McDonald and knocked him back toward the end zone very quickly.
I'll tell you, you know what his nickname is? Tasmanian Devil. When you have a Tasmanian Devil running down on a kickoff, you got something.
Things happen as Barry Redden whirls over the left side for a gain of 4. Stopped by safety man Curtis Jordan and Rich Mallott. Redden, as John Madden said earlier, Redden is expected by the Rams to carry the ball 15 times. Dickerson 30 at least. Second and 6 it'll be. Dickerson by man.
Yeah, that's one play that the Rams have in special for this game. They're going to key the defensive end, which would be man in that case. If he works out or up the field, Dickerson's going to cut back in. If he stays tight, they'll go out around him.
Ball, face mask, number 71 on the defense. 15-yard penalty, first down.
This is a 15-yard penalty. This is the industrial version of this penalty. See, now, when he sees man outside, he's going to cut back inside. Now, man grabs a face mask there. And I guess he must have twisted or did some other things down below. Because they have two varieties, the 5 and the 15. And that was the 15. I'm not sure why.
Industrial. I like that. Gordon McCarter's the referee, by the way. That's Redden hit right at the line of scrimmage. No gain for that one. Rams owner, Giorgio Frontieri, owner and president of the Los Angeles Rams. She's just trying to stay warm, not block out the crowd noise. Second down and 10, and time for us to have another good look at rookie quarterback Jim Everett. 6'5". He can see over a lot of folks. He can also overthrow some folks.
Well, I think he had to on that one, Pat. The middle linebacker, Neil Okowitz, number 52, was on a blitz, and no one picked him up. Watch him right here, right in the middle of the screen. See 52, he comes on a delayed blitz. Now, no one picks him up, and right there, Everett sees that, knows that he either has to take the sack or get rid of the ball.
10, Redden moves to the sideline. They'll go with 3 wide receivers down. Ron Brown didn't know if he was going to play or not, but he's the 3rd. Split wide to the right. Great speed. Redskins with a blitz again. Everett.
Jackie Slater and Charles Mann, right there to Slater, the all-pro, blocking against Mann. The play was over, and they kept going.
Again, Gordon McCarter is the referee. He's the one in the black hat.
I hope this isn't one of those against both guys so nothing happens.
It very well could be, though.
Well, he's explaining it to Curtis Jordan first. Oh, they call it against Slater.
John Robinson doesn't necessarily agree.
unnecessary roughness. Number 78 on the offensive team. The foul occurred after the incompletion. The down counts, fourth down.
Slater was just out there, just an offensive tackle, just out there working, and he just kept blocking against Charles Mann. Threw a flag, says you can't do that. You got to stop.
I thought for a moment he'd been thrown out of the game, but he hasn't. Eric Yarber is number 80. Hatcher back to punt. Yarber standing at the Redskin 35 as the Rams take a long time. 7:13 left to play, first quarter. Redskins leading 3-0. The time run down on the 32nd clock, and they'll move them back five. I'm not sure why, unless they were not sure about their offensive or punting alignment.
Relay of game, offense, still fourth down.
Well, that's something that there's sure no way that they'd want to do that. And, you know, they had one guy split out on the right, the other end tight on the left, and it looked like they were trying to audibleize to get maybe two guys in tight. We'll see, because that's the way they're starting now. That's what it was. They were trying to get their other end to come in. And they wanted a tight punt formation like they have now. See all the guys there. They couldn't get it, so they just took too much time.
Redskin pressure, but the kick is a good one. Yarber. Got it. Takes a ram, bounce, goes out of bounds, and the Redskins will take over at about their own 40-yard line. 41-yard punt, no return. Redskins lead 3-0, 7:03 left first quarter.
The human eye is remarkably sensitive to light. That's why we make the GE Soft White Bulb. An ordinary frosted bulb has a glaring hot spot because it doesn't have the high diffusion coating of the GE Soft White. A soft, warm, glowing light that's sensitive to the needs of the human eye. Now there's a new GE Soft White specifically designed to give you a brighter, soft light that's better for reading. The GE Soft White Reader Light.
Why sit in the doldrums when you can ride the crest?
The Atlantic Difference.
The Atlantic Difference, 8% on your money market, guaranteed for 2 months. Call 1-800-4-ATLANTIC and make more money with Atlantic's money market. 8% guaranteed for 2 months. Visit a branch or call Atlantic for an 8% money market. Atlantic Financial.
Every 34 seconds, somebody else buys a new Chevrolet Cavalier. But now you can get $300 cash back on Cavalier sedans, $300 on Cavalier wagons, $300 on Cavalier convertibles. Cash back from Chevrolet. See your dealer now for details. You must take actual retail delivery from dealer stock by January 5th, or watch the Cavaliers pass you by. There goes another one.
The heartbeat of America, that's today's Chevrolet.
7:03 left first quarter. Washington 3-0, Jay Schrader, the Redskin quarterback. And he'll be facing this Ram defensive unit. Three-man front, Reed Miller in the middle and Reggie Doss. Owens, Giroux, Eckern, and Mike Wilcher, the linebackers. And in the secondary, Jerry Gray and Leroy Irvin on the corners. And the two safety men, Nolan Cromwell and Vince Newsom. Schrader coming over for a last-minute check with the sideline. Led the NFC in passing yardage. 22 touchdowns and an equal number of interceptions. Most of them late in the year. Clark comes wide to the left. Monk, wide right. Didier on the move, and now Warren behind him. George Rogers. Looked as if he had early room, and then it closed up in a hurry. Let by Mark Giroux. A gain of two. The offensive group for the Redskins. Schrader, the quarterback. Rogers, the lone setback usually. Monk and Clark wide, and then they do different things with Warren and Didier. Up front, Jacoby and Grimm. Bostic, R.C. Thielman, and Mark
see, Donnie Warren only caught 20 balls all season, and he's used mostly as a blocker, as we said earlier. But I think the more zone that you play against the Redskins, and I think Jay Schrader's the type of guy who's going to get a lot of zone, the more you have to get your tight end involved. So I think we're going to see Donnie Warren and Clint Didier get more passes today.
Third and short. Out of sync. Rodgers got enough. But flags flew early. Doug Reed made the stop. Going to be against the Redskins.
For being out of sync. You said they were out of sync, and the official, boom, they threw the flag and said out of sync.
Illegal motion. Number 63, offense. 5 yard penalty, repeat third down.
That's Raleigh McKenzie, number 63. See him, he comes in as tight end. He's a backup guard, but he comes in and plays tight end on short yardage. And you see, he's not used to being out there on that end.
That makes it third and six.
He's not used to being in there, period. Jumps offside.
Part of the heavy jumbo package. Replace Rodgers. That's moving. Schrader back to throw. Has some time for Didier. Ball bounding around. Covered by Leroy Irvin. Knocked down, but a flag down.
And that flag came out there late too, Pat. I don't know about this one. This one was after the ball went down.
Or at least after the ball is deflected.
I don't think that can be pass interference on Leroy Irvin. That was good defense. He was out there man-to-man on Clint Didier.
If that's what the call is, after that ball is deflected, that belongs to anyone.
You see, I think the field judge is coming in there and telling the back judge.
Number 47 on the defense. Automatic first down.
Now, I don't think that's right. I thought that was good defense. I thought that Irvin and the ball arrived about the same time. Watch it, it's right here. That's Didier, the receiver. Irvin starts to go back, comes up. He has to be able to go for the ball. I don't see any interference on that.
There might be a review. I think another penalty marker has been thrown. Leroy Irvin obviously really upset.
Eye conduct, number 47 on the defense, still first down.
I know what he's upset about. I mean, he's out there, he's playing against a 6'5", 240-pound guy. The ball's in the air. He has to be able to do something. Watch it again. Here it comes to Didier. He's coming up. He has a right to go for the ball. He sticks his left arm around him. He knocks the ball out of there. I don't know what the guy has to do. I mean, you can't let him do nothing back there. Just let him catch the ball.
Got to play defense, don't you? Schrader going right to work out to him. Hit hard early and quickly by Jerry Gray, but he still got 7 yards. That's what he'll think about for a while.
That's what he's telling him. Art Monk is not a talkative guy anyway. Jerry Gray said something to him, and Art Monk said something right back to him. There could be some guys in the league that can be intimidated. Art Monk is not one of them.
Never has been.
Never will be.
Second down and three. Redskins on the move at the Ram. 22-yard line. Make it the 21. Rodgers over the left side. First down. Gain of four. Redskins leading 3-0. Reggie Doss made the stop.
Over the years, the Redskins have made a lot of mileage over that left side, right in there behind Russ Grimm and Joe Jacoby. You can talk about all-pro linemen, but I think when you get Bostic to center and Grimm and Jacoby healthy, they're as too good of offensive linemen as there are in this league.
And over the years, as you say, they have been. Those two side-by-side are a full truckload. About the 13, Sean Miller tripped him up.
I know, you know, we look at both sidelines here, and I think both of them went in with that same type of game plan to get control of the game,
early.
Control the ball early, run it, let your offensive line dominate their defensive line. Thus far, the Redskins have done it.
Neither one of them, John, feel that they have great come-from-behind teams.
Well, the Rams have had some tough breaks. They had a turnover, and they've had 30 yards of penalties on this drive.
That's Rodgers dodging, gets back to about the line of scrimmage, and that's about it before Vince Newsom knocked him down.
Trying to get in there. See, they have the scoop block. Grimm gets his guy. They don't get the linebacker, and Newsom, who's the safety, was up in the backfield. That's always tough because you don't account for those safeties.
Third down and 7. Kelvin Bryant. Line up deep. Schrader back to throw. Kelvin Bryant out of the backfield. Touchdown, Redskins. He got it.
George Rogers doing the running work, Kelvin Bryant coming in for Rogers and doing the passing work out of the backfield.
Atkinson for the extra point. Schrader holding to make it 10-0. And does. Here's the touchdown.
One thing about Jay Schrader, he's going to look deep. He's not going to look for the short guy. He's going to look for the guy in the end zone, and he finds him.
Redskins lead 10-0, 2:26 left first quarter.
At first, IBM electric typewriters made typing easier. Then we improved the way typing looked and revolutionized its touch and feel. IBM even fixed the way errors got fixed. Today, IBM wheel writers and quiet writers do things our old typewriters never dreamed of. They're faster, quieter. They have memory and can even signal mistakes as you make them. The typewriter secretaries like best just get better and better.
So what are you going to do for the holidays, man?
Going home, D. Hear that, Mr. Seagram? This little old bottle of Seagram's Golden Wine Cooler's got to sell itself for a while. I'm out of here. I'm going home.
Guess I told him, didn't I?
Asia after 60,000 miles. Europe after 40,000. Continental U.S. only 20,000 miles. Look whose frequent flyer program serves up the world faster.
Northwest! Listen to the heartbeat of America.
In a 350 V8 Chevy with the most available power of any half-ton pickup. Nothing works like a Chevy truck.
The heartbeat of America. That's today's Chevy truck.
Southwest Conference winner Texas A&M battles Big Ten co-champion Ohio State in the 51st annual Cotton Bowl Classic, New Year's Day on CBS Sports.
Between the Rams and the Redskins. And Jay Schrader just hit Kelvin Bryant with a 14-yard touchdown pass. The Redskins lead it 10-0. Mickey Sutton and Charles White back deep as Steve Cox kicks it off. A knuckler. Trying to find a handle is Sutton, and he finally does, and finally comes out of the pack. He's hit by Darryl Green, and finally, with some help from some more Redskins, he's down at the 25.
Let's watch the touchdown again. Here's Kelvin Bryant. He's just going to run right through the zone here and catch a touchdown pass here. But watch the move that he makes. He makes the old street head fake right here. Watch him right there. See, he turns and looks out. That brings him up, takes him really taking a bite, and now he runs right through him. Watch him. You see, they take the bite on that head fake. He runs right through him, splits the entire zone.
25. The Rams give it to Dickerson. And Dickerson gets a couple of tough yards. Calvin Daniels, there's the man who scored the touchdown.
Hey, you know, last week he got hit against the Eagles, and they found on Monday he had blood in his urine. So they hospitalized him, checked his ribs and kidneys, and then they didn't know early in the week if he'd even be able to play this week. But he came out, practiced later in the week, talked to him yesterday and said he's fine. Everything cleared up.
Henry Ellard is split wide to the right. Oh, he's got a man. Look out. Kevin House had about four steps on the nearest defender, who was Curtis Jordan, and he finally got him down. If he had been able to stay on his feet, the Rams would have been on the scoreboard.
Well, the Redskins are in a zone. You see, Tim Morrison was looking into the backfield. Kevin House just ran right by Morrison. Then the safety, Curtis Jordan, didn't get over there. I'll tell you, Everett just got that ball off.
Saw that completion. 45-yard gain, they say now. Ram first down inside the Redskin 30. Dickerson deep. But Redden gets the carry, and Redden gets only a couple. Darryl Grant tripped him up.
You know what the Redskins are doing? They're putting Darryl Green, who's their all-pro corner, number 28 there, they're putting him man-to-man on Henry Ellard, figuring that Ellard is the best of the Rams receivers. And then they're letting Tim Morrison, who's the rookie, cover Kevin House. I wouldn't be surprised if the Rams go to House more today than they go to Ellard.
Well, the House got open. This probably, unless it's a quick incompletion, is the last play of the first quarter. Now it's Redden in motion, and that's Dickerson hammering into the Redskins secondary down to the 20. A gain of seven. Be the end of the first quarter, dominated by turnovers in the Redskins as they lead it 10-0 at RFK Stadium.
Today, millions of Americans are better off than ever before. Better off with expertise on how to manage cash, finance mortgages, and accumulate assets. Better off with the finest insurance protection for their lives, property, and businesses. They're better off under the umbrella of one of America's largest diversified financial enterprises, the Travelers. Have you looked under the Travelers umbrella lately?
Listen to the heartbeat of America.
When you've got what it takes, put yourself in today's Chevrolet Celebrity Eurosport and listen to your heartbeat.
The heartbeat of America. Today's Chevrolet.
The game that counts, the pressure mounts, the kickoff's almost here.
Right now, all the way.
Now you're
Let's
talking
go.
Football. Now you're talking beer.
Now you're talking good times.
Stroh's, fire brewed for smooth, consistent taste.
Now you're talking Stroh's. Now you're talking beer. Now you're talking good times. And Stroh's is spoken here.
The NFL on CBS. Playoffs. We're at the wild card game at RFK Stadium between the Rams and the Redskins. And at the end of the first quarter, Washington 10, the Rams nothing. Washington had five first downs in the first quarter. The Rams had four. But penalties and turnovers, quick ones, helped the Redskins get to the scoreboard. A touchdown pass from Schrader to Kelvin Bryant, and a field goal by is how they molded the lead. Third down. Redden and Dickerson in the backfield. Redden coming out. Hand off Dickerson, and he gets the first down. Hurls himself down to about the 17. Todd Bowles again on the stop along with Charles Mann.
You know, the interesting thing about that play is how Dickerson can start, and he's just running to the left. He starts to the left, and then he's just going to cut and go any place he can. Watch him here. He starts here out. Boom! He sees something, hits it back to the inside, wherever he finds a soft spot.
And he can find him. On first down, Dickerson again, looking for the soft spot. Ball came loose. Flag is down. Fumble. Flags. Redskins have the ball, but hold with a second.
Countdown will begin.
A close encounter.
It doesn't make sense.
A deadly plan.
Oh, no.
Brand new action from the Wizard.
No! Jump, Simon!
Out there, two celebrations are taking place. I'm Jeff Bostic of the Washington Redskins, and we're celebrating our 50th anniversary. From 1937 to 1986, the legends and eras of greatness, the coaches and players who won two world titles in Super Bowl 17. Behind it all was Jack Kent Cook, whose commitment and love for his teams and his community made it all possible. And that love of community is what also is being celebrated here in Washington and in 2,000 communities across the nation, as 30 million United Way volunteers celebrate the United Way centennial, 100 years of service to the country. The United Way is founded on the idea that says people care. So join me and the Washington Redskins as we celebrate our 50th anniversary and be a part of the United Way centennial. See all that we've been and all that we can become together. The United Way, thanks to you, it works for all of us, the United Way.
This message furnished by the National Football League.
All League is sponsored by the Heartbeat of America, today's Chevrolet. Stroh's and Stroh Light, now you're talking good times, and Stroh's is spoken here. And by The Travelers, one of America's strongest, most experienced financial experts.
Let's watch the last play here. Right here is the hole. We see David Hill with a hole there, so that's a penalty they call. Now let's see the fumble again. Neil Okowicz, number 52, is going to come in and hit Dickerson and knock the ball out. There he is right there. See him hit it with his right hand. Right there. That knocks the ball out, and the Redskins come up with the fumble. That's Dickerson's second fumble today. He had 15 during the regular season and lost 11 of them.
That would be about the only negative for that man, Eric Dickerson. Two today.
Held him back today. He's had two, and then, of course, they had 30 yards of fumble on that one Redskin touchdown drive.
Here's Rodgers. Right up the middle. Got a couple. Doug Reed stopped him. It'll bring up a second down and about eight. Selection of plays so far. The Rams running as they wanted to. 12 against four passes. The Redskins as they wanted to, with balance. Second and eight. Didier split wide left. The handoff is to Rodgers, and Rodgers outside the 15, about the 17. He'll still need a little bit more to move the sticks in a first down. Offensive unit, Dennis Harris sitting up on top of the bench, and Jackie Slater to his left. Third and two. I don't think any defense that the Redskins play could be too much of a surprise to that offensive unit. Third down and two. Sanders split wide to the right. Monk was in motion. Slater with time. The middle, ball in the air, batted around, deflected, and the Redskins will
made a heck of an interception. He had a couple bounces there. Then he was falling to the ground, almost came up with that thing.
Here's the almost.
Look at it, he's going down. He gets a tip with the right hand, tips it up over, and he tipped it right out of reach.
Steve Cox back deep. The Redskins and Henry Ellard, dangerous punt returner for the Rams. Line drive kick. He should have some room to operate. Hit down by the Redskins' Jeff Bostic, who does the snapping. A 50-yard punt by Cox. The return of eight. The Rams take over.
This is an AT&T Long Distance Command Center, where our engineers make sure your calls go right through. It's a unique system only AT&T can bring you, with thousands of ways to get from here to there. And there are seven more centers like it, because we're not about to take chances that busy circuits could keep you waiting.
Well, she definitely has my hair.
For over 100 years, when you reached out, we were there. And you can keep it that way. AT&T, the right choice.
It's your money, son. But if you want my advice, buy another Subaru.
Sure, Dad.
I thought we agreed you'd buy a Subaru.
But, Dad, I did.
See your participating Subaru dealer January 12th through 23rd, and you could win your own Subaru XT.
Look at that face. Isn't there a face you'd like to see?
We are temptation.
That I'd like to see you
give in to temptation.
Why fight it? This winter, United's low fares can take you to more places than any other airline. So give in. Go home to mother.
We.
Who loves you, baby?
Our temptation.
Tonight, wanted men from the past, a bizarre journey into the future.
Houston. You cowboys want to show them?
Outlaws, tonight on CBS.
The home of the Redskins, RFK Stadium in Washington. And the Redskins lead at home, where they're oh so very tough. 10-0. So far, that pretty much tells you the story of the game. Eric Dickerson has fumbled twice, and the Redskins have recovered both. Schrader, 14-yard touchdown pass to Kelvin Bryant. And Atkinson, a 25-yard field goal. It's 10-0. Penalties have been a factor already. Most of them against the Rams. The give is to Eric Dickerson, right side. He got two. Alvin Walton, the young safety man who has acquired a reputation as being quite a hitter in this Redskin defense.
You know, one of the things Joe Gibbs was talking about is defense. He said, we just can't get any fumbles anymore. We aren't recovering fumbles. So far, they have two in this first half. The Redskins are the only team in the playoffs that had a minus in the turnover ratio.
Usually that makes quite a difference. Here's Everett. Up the middle, tight end David Hill into Redskin territory. Walton again on the stop, but that's a Ram first down.
Hey, Jim Everett hung in there because he's going to get pressure. Watch Dexter Manley takes an inside move on Irv Pankey, and he's right at his feet. He was, at his knees, and Mann was high. You see him, he got the old 1-2. Manley blow, and Charles Mann up on top.
Everett, nothing but praises about his future. Nothing but bright hopes as a human being and as a player. Dickerson slipped as he came out of the emblem in the middle of the field, and Everett just got the ball to him. He lost three. Olkowitz led the defense.
I think this was a counter play. Watch Dickerson. I think he's going to step to the left, see, and then come back to the right. But as he started to go to the right, he slipped right in that emblem thing, as you say, could never get going, and the Redskins had four jerseys right there on top of him.
Second down and 13. splits in a hurry. David Hill again. Out of bounds, chased by Alvin Walton. David has not been very much a member of the Ram receiving core, but the last two have been clutch ones.
Well, you know, they even take David Hill out and they put in Darren Long when they go to the passing game. Hill is really the blocker. And, of course, you know, that's the thing that they're looking out for. They can then, boom, they sneak him in the middle and then across on that one, get two plays to Hill.
Third and one. That was a gain of 12. Hill's second reception. But Dickerson is the man with the football and the Ram first down. Pickup of four. Curtis Jordan finally tripped him up.
Well, that's where they go in there. You talk about those Pro Bowl linemen. Dennis Hare, the right guard. Jackie Slater, the right tackle. And then David Hill. You take that ball on short yardage. And if you have three all-pro guys, just get right in behind them. It's what they're all-pro for. They help you get first down.
One man short, Tim Tyrell just hustled into the lineup. And now, because of that short number of people, they take a timeout. That's their first. That'll mean they have two left in the first half. 10:03 left in the first half with the Redskins leading 10-0.
When you hear the mention of two or beef, your heart starts thumping to the Big Mac beat. You gotta get a Big Mac. And that's a fact. You're having a Big Mac attack. Your stomach growls out with a battle cry.
Big attack.
Beat your McDonald's. You know why.
Big Mac attack.
Attack it with your bare hands.
Hey,
team's getting ready for the master plan.
Two
army.
Patty special.
Some lettuce cheese.
John's gonna work.
Have no mercy.
B-I-G-M-A-C.
Hey.
One.
Two more fights. It's history.
Being grown up is more complicated than playing grown up. That's why Nationwide Insurance has simplified financial planning with our Universal Life Policy. It's a new generation of life insurance that gives you competitive interest rates, plus tax advantages, and is flexible enough to change as your life changes, to give you the kind of blanket protection you need throughout your life.
Heart surgery. To perform it, doctors need vital information. At an IBM scientific center in England, computer researchers and doctors are transforming X-rays into three-dimensional models of a patient's arteries and beating heart. This experimental project is an example of innovation at IBM, and it could be another way computers help doctors save lives.
Their goal, Super Bowl. Their obstacle, each other. Next weekend, the NFC playoff battles continue on CBS Sports.
Of course, until this one is over, John, we don't know who'll be where, but we'll be in New York. And I don't know, going in, what team do you think?
Well, I always like the intensity of the playoffs. I mean, I think there are some lookout teams. Teams you better look out for. I think, obviously, the Giants are one. I don't think you can count those Bears out because
no,
the defense
indeed.
Is too good. Then the lookout team, I think, is a team out in San Francisco, the 49ers. I think at the end of the season, they could be playing the best of anyone in the NFC.
In terms of balance, I think, as you said, the Bears' defense, the Giants' defense. But look out for the 49ers. Look out for the Rams. Look out for David Hill. He's a factor. Ball is on the ground. And it looks like it must be a fumble. Nobody has indicated otherwise. Neil Okulich came up with it. David Hill is still back here. And now the official back at the spot where Hill went down says he was down. And they're going to bring it all back, I think.
They are bringing it back. They're going to give the ball back to the Rams or the Redskins. The official, Al Jury, was standing right there, and he stayed right there, and he kept pointing to the position.
Bouquet's knee is down, in possession of the football. Still a ball.
Still, the Rams ball. Look at it.
That's watch it here to see if he went down. There's the knee down right there. He had possession. Now, after that, he loses possession. So what he said is right. He had possession when the knee went down.
Still a Rams ball. Second and eight.
I think they're going to look at that on instant replay, though, Pat. They just stopped the play, so they're talking to the referee. They're talking to the umpire who talks to the referee.
And Dexter Manley is up saying, hey, it should be ours.
I think the key here is when the knee goes down. When the knee's down, he's going to blow the whistle. The knee's down now. Who has the ball?
He does.
He does. And it's okay.
The play is being reviewed.
Gordon McCarter, the referee. Play is still being reviewed. Joe Gardy is the NFL official in charge at whom you just looked.
The official there is Al Jury. He's a highway patrolman in California. He gets it during the week, and he comes out and gets you in the weekends.
Approximately total plays 35,000. That's mind-boggling. The reversals, not many. 38, another indicative statistic of what an outstanding job the officials do, and they're still reviewing. Gordon McCarter on the right of your picture. Conference moves further away from the players.
You know, this the one thing about instant replay, it's very vulnerable. And it's easy for someone to say that it takes too long and they shouldn't do it. There's Jack Kent Cook, of course, the owner of the Redskins, and he's not thinking it's taking too long. He just wants it to be the Redskins' ball. Dexter Manley's trying to get the crowd going. He's trying to get the crowd to help that guy up in the boat. That's Jack Fetty, the official there. Now, in the playoffs, they have all-star officiating crew. This crew doesn't work together. They're picked for the playoffs based on their grades during the regular season. So it's not a crew. It's the top referees, top umpires, field judges, and so on.
That doesn't mean that they can't work again down the road somewhere in the playoffs. And they're still reviewing.
That's it. You know, again, the knee's down. Now, I don't know. They make look. Does he have possession?
It could be ruled if they decide he didn't have possession. It could be just an incomplete pass. And they're still talking about it. That's Joe Cardi on the left.
I don't know if it changes. But I'll tell you, I mean, as I was saying earlier, it is a vulnerable thing, and it's easy to criticize, and this situation is very easy for everyone to say they ought to do away with it. I don't think that's the answer. I think you have to stay with it, keep it. It's going to help football.
And the review continues. 9:41 left to play in the first half. Redskins 10.
Be the other thing, is it a complete pass or right. An incomplete pass? Is it a fumble or not a fumble?
Was his knee down?
His knee was down, but did he have control of the ball or not?
John Robinson with a little bit of disgust in his mind, and Joe Gibbs looking on and conversing with people up in the press box. The Redskins are saying and starting a chant now. Continue to review.
Well, see, number 106 there, the back judge, he's the guy that made the call. So he's the guy that they have to talk into and see what he said.
Instant replay is reviewed and determined that the ball was fumbled, recovered by the Redskins.
Look at that one. I guess he can they say that his knee hit and the ball wasn't fumbled yet, but there was no control of it.
Third turnover by the Rams. Third fumble by the Rams. And the Redskins have it at their own 45. They lead 10-0 already. Now the offensive unit, Redskins on the field, and the Rams defense ready to go. And is taken down almost at the line of scrimmage by Greg Meisner.
What the ruling was, Pat, is they thought the ball was loose before his knee hit the ground. It hadn't been fumbled to the ground, but they thought it was loose before the knee hit the ground.
Second down and 10, Redskins. Their own 45. They lead 10-0. Just over 9 minutes left in the first half. Monk was the man in motion. Outside quickly, Rogers. They set that up nicely. The lineman got out in front, but so did the Ram defense after a gain of four. Meisner was the first man there.
They're going to have to think when they have these long instant replays, as we watch a replay of the screen, of letting these guys have another warm-up after they stand out there and they wait. They all get a little cold and tight. They have to kind of start the game over again.
Rogers leaves. Of course, normally he would leave in this situation anyway. Bryant takes his place, third and six.
You know, the advantage of having a guy like Kelvin Bryant in there is usually your best cover guys are on the corners, the next best on the third end, and he's playing against the fourth or fifth best cover guy.
Out of the backfield he comes. Enough for the first down. Johnny Johnson was the first Ram on location.
Hey, this Gary Clark is something. He was injured a couple weeks ago, an ankle injury against Denver. Really hadn't played nor practiced since then. We were out here watching him in practice yesterday. He didn't do anything, just stood around all day. And then on Sunday, game day, playoff time, he gets it up to play.
His first NFL playoff game. He wound up second in the NFC. Rodgers back in the game behind Schrader. Rodgers takes the fake and Schrader goes deep for Didier. Ooh. That was close to being a 17-0 or at least 16-0. Redskin lead. Leroy Irvin back with Didier, who's playing with an injured hand in all fairness.
And there's Vince Newsome, the safety. Didier gets behind both of them. I'll tell you, don't tell Jay Schrader you can't throw deep against his zone. Jay Schrader has his own mind. A lot of quarterbacks look short and then go deeper, look short, medium, and deep. Jay Schrader looks deep, wants to throw deep, and then comes back.
Get it upfield. He believes in that. Kelvin Bryant to Schrader's left. That's Didier again in motion. Schrader to Bryant. 3-yard gain.
See, now you see the quarterback giving the signals. He's telling the bench the down and distance or the distance to go. And then sometimes the quarterback can signal to the bench what he wants. So he signaled six, whatever that meant. Tell you, pretty good protection. You see, they have that good protection. Give him a good pocket. Oh, Russ Grimm going against Gary Jeter. He just keeps going. The ball's been thrown. Oh, Grimm's still blocking.
Jeter thought he'd been held. This time,
big play guy. You know, Sanders is one of those guys, rookie USFL guy, who makes big plays. Joe Gibbs says last week against the Eagles, Sanders made one of the best catches he's ever seen in his life. He said he just has a feeling downfield in that open field of being able to adjust and get to any ball.
And very soft hands. Says you never hear the ball when he catches it.
Calls him a big yardage guy.
First down, Redskins. And the Rams 29. Rodgers to the 20 or 21. Eckern picked him up, but Rodgers got 8.
You know, the Redskins are playing the type of game that both teams wanted to play. Watch the left side of the line there. Watch Grimm, 68. Jacoby, 66. Watch the movement. Grimm fires out. Jacoby gets his guy going back. Grimm is out there, and that's a big hole for Rodgers. I'll tell you, did you see Joe Jacoby
and
Reggie Doss?
Yes.
Oof. That's what you call taking
backwards.
Him for a ride.
Second down. They need two for a first. They'll give again to Rodgers, and he'll have the first.
Teams, Pat, get $6,000 for this game. The right guard of the Redskins, R.C. Thielman, he wants to buy a tractor with his money. Everyone was excited about getting in the playoffs. Thielman was excited because he said he could buy a John Deere tractor now.
Washington in this drive. Still falls for a gain of 2.
I think Greg Meisner got penetration there. I don't think Jeff Bostic got Meisner, number 69. And if you're going to run the ball, you have to get some movement on that nose tackle. You can't let him get any penetration. Watch your nose tackle right over the center. You see, he gets penetration. It's a double team. He just split that thing and got in there enough to knock the ball carry off.
Second and 8, Kelvin Bryant replaces Rodgers. Bryant gets the carry. Inside the 5 to about the 3 is Bryant. Maybe the 2. Wilshire finally got him down. First down, Redskins, a gain of 9 by Bryant.
I tell you, talking about the nose tackle, what's the job that they do on the nose tackle this time? If he gets here, you can't, but if you get him going back here, you can run. Now watch the fire out there. Bostic starts out. Thielman helps him. They get him going backwards. See, then they get him turned, and that's the hole that Kelvin Bryant could get in. If you get that guy going backwards, you're always going to have a big soft spot in there.
And that runner is going to have a place to go. Rodgers is back. Ram on the scene.
You know, it's a funny thing. We talk about the nose tackle. You get 2 plays. He makes a play. They don't make anything. Then the play that they get him going backwards is when they make the run.
Second and goal from just outside the 4. 10-0 Redskins leading the Rams. That's George Rodgers looking ahead and hoping. About the 1.5-yard line, tripped up by Wilshire.
They have the big thing. They have Donnie Warren, who's right in front of Rodgers. He's looking. He knows he's going to get the ball, reading the whole thing, getting right in behind Warren, then seeing there's nothing there, then cutting back against the grain. Remember, years ago, or a few years ago, when they used to have John Riggins, you always knew 2 things. 1, Riggins was going to get the ball here. 2, on the left side.
2 minutes remaining in the first half, and the Redskins leading 10-0.
The Winning Edge, brought to you by Seagram's Golden Wine Cooler. The Winning Edge can go to the sure of foot. Place kickers get the call when it counts. George Blanda answered the call more often than any kicker in NFL history. His legend was made in 1970 when, at the age of 43, Blanda quarterbacked and kicked the Oakland Raiders to 4 wins and a tie in the final seconds of 5 straight games. Blanda's golden toe provided the Raiders with the winning edge.
It's body time!
Hey, hey, hey!
No, Seagram's golden wine coins. You guys
want to
put me out of a job?
Right.
Oh, we're bound. Sully,
you know I was coming.
No, I knew they were coming.
You must be doing something right.
You did one thing right.
You came home for the holidays.
I want to talk to you about something that could change your life. Insurance. This is a policy from one of the world's biggest insurance specialists. For almost any kind of insurance, because you just never know when you're going to need insurance. Excuse me. Hey, you big ape! You know who has to pay for this mess?
Transamerica. For insurance and financial services, the power of the pyramid is working for you.
Stadium, the Redskins leading the Rams 10-0, 2 minutes left, first half. Pat Summerall and John Madden. It's third down and goal. The ball's at the 2. The Redskins have taken out Jumbo Heavy, or Heavy Jumbo, and put back in the receivers, Clark and Monk. So it looks like they might put it up.
Well, I would think that it would be some kind of play pass, or maybe that's just what the Redskins want the Rams to think, and they're going to run, but they did go from a running formation to a passing formation. And it sure looks like pass to me.
Clark and Monk both split wide to the left. Kelvin Bryant behind Schrader. Spread out left. Schrader's got some room himself. But he doesn't get in. Leroy Irvin stopped him. No gain. Not what they had in mind. And now they'll have to settle field goal.
Well, I think it was one of those things that they were looking for, where he's going to roll out here, and he's looking, he doesn't have anyone, he doesn't have Monk in there right then. He had to decide to run. He had the blockers in front of him, but Leroy Irvin got through that line of blockers and made the tackle.
Atkinson on the scene, out on the field. This will be about 21 yards away for this field goal attempt, with Schrader holding. He has made one. He's been successful from 25 yards out. They let the clock run down as long as they can, and they let it run out. And now they'll back him up a little bit. And now a timeout, Redskins. They used as much of the clock as they could and then took the timeout. They lead 10-0. The Redskins do. 108 left in the first half.
Your mission, Paul, is to get these pictures developed, but you must remember to ask for Color Watch.
Color Watch, 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 Color Watch.
For great film developing, make sure your dealer uses only Kodak products. But to get that assurance, remember to ask for... Color Watch. The Kodak Color Watch system helps make great developing possible.
A lot of people are disappointed with the traction they're getting from their present car, which is why more and more of them are looking into the number one four-wheel drive car in America at their Subaru dealer.
So the issue is clear. Sony Video 8, the system of the future, or VHS-C, the compromise of the past. Now, as we've seen, the new Sony Handycam with autofocus and zoom gives you a measurably better picture, far superior sound, twice the recording time, and on Sony video cassettes, your memories are safe. While on VHS-C, they could be fleeting. I rest my case.
The Sony Video 8 system. Judge for yourself.
10-0 Redskins over the Rams. Redskins win. going to play the Bears. Darkness gathering, the Capitol, that magnificent sight, the Washington Monument in the background. Renovations, of course, going on the Capitol building of this country. Schrader now right at the 10-yard line, and so it'll be a 20-yard field goal attempt by Jess Atkinson. Yes, I'm ready. And yes, it's good. And it's 13-0 with a minute, 5 seconds left to play in the first half. The Redskins over the Rams. They've been able to move and take advantage of turnovers.
Dear Subaru, my Subaru was caught right in the middle of Hurricane Gloria.
Dear Subaru, my Subaru was caught in the eruption of Mount St. Helens.
Other cars were overcome by heavy floods, but my Subaru kept on going.
Other cars were stalled by volcanic ash, but my Subaru got us through.
I don't think you're going to hear a story to top mine.
I'd like to see somebody top my story.
Subaru. To own one is to love one.
Rollo, where's the package?
I have no idea. And the Air Express company has no idea either.
Hold it. If you'd used Federal Express, you wouldn't be having this problem. Come with me. Federal tracks your package with scanners from where it's picked up to where it's delivered. Giving you its exact status within 30 minutes or your money back.
Next time, send it Federal Express. Why fool around with anyone else?
I had no idea Federal did that. Absolutely no idea.
It's one thing to say you fight friction. It's another thing to prove it. Kendall Motor Oil did. First, ordinary piston rings were plated with pure gold. Then, a prestigious independent laboratory ran them under stop-and-go driving conditions for 5,000 miles. The results? Look, Kendall protected the soft gold. A remarkable test only Kendall has taken. Now, doesn't that tell you something? Kendall Motor Oil, for protection worth its weight in gold.
But RFK Stadium and the Washington Redskins are ahead of the Los Angeles Rams 13-0. And I'm in the Redskins owner's box, Mr. Jack Kent Cook. Mr. Cook, there was a long delay in the second quarter on an instant replay ruling. What did you see?
I saw a fumble, and I'm so pleased to see that our instant replay eye in the sky saw what I saw. The only thing I couldn't understand, Irv, why it took them so long to arrive at that conclusion. It was so obvious to me. Wasn't it to you?
There's a question in my mind.
That's right, it was
obvious. Would you vote in favor of instant replay?
Oh, I'd vote in favor of it. I think even had that gone against us, it would have been an absolute terrible error.
Okay.
But had it gone against us...
Thanks very much, Mr. Cook. Let's get back to the game, okay? Pat?
Flag down, as you can see on the other side of the pileup, a return of 17 yards by Mickey Sutton. And it looks like it could be against the Rams, and they have had nothing but misfortune in the first half. The Redskins lead it 13-0.
Well, you know, the Rams have had misfortune, but I think that the Redskin defense is playing the type of defense that is causing that.
Illegal block, number 32, receiving team during the return. Off the distance penalty, first down.
You know, they're hustling all over the field. They're tackling the ball. They're just kind of smothering that entire Ram offense.
They're doing what Joe Gibbs said to us Friday and again yesterday that they hope to do. Draw play to Redden. Redden out of the pack. Barry Redden out of bounds after a Ram first down, knocked out by Curtis Jordan. He got 13 yards.
I'll tell you, Barry Redden almost knocked out Darryl Green. Green was a corner here, had to come up and support. I'll tell you, he came up like he was going to make the tackle. Watch, it'll be right here in the bottom of the screen. Watch 28. He comes, I got him, I got him, I got him. I'm going to square in on him, zero up on him. Whap! He just ran right through that tackle.
Not much web.
Well, it was a little rough. It didn't work. That Redden's a strong guy.
52 seconds still remain. Manley on the rush. They give the screen pass to Dickerson. He got a little room and gets another Ram first down. In the meantime, there's a penalty marker down, and so is Dexter Manley down. A gain of 13. holding.
Manley went after him. He started to jump up, started to go into fight. That was Duval Love. Manley went down. Then he was out. Then he came out of it, jumped up, and went after Love.
A delayed man.
Duval Love says, what'd he do?
Holding number 67 on the offense. Pass the distance penalty, repeat the down.
Duval Love.
Well, it's Duval Love is there, number 67. He's blocking Manley. Now he's going to get caught right there for a hold and a takedown. You see, he gets the knee. That's the thing that made Manley mad. See, now Manley's down. He's like he's out. See, he gets him here. He doesn't mind being hold. That makes him mad, but getting the knee really makes him mad. He gets the flag, he's down, he's out for a while, then he jumps up and goes after Love. I don't know why Duval Love is in there.
I don't either. I was about to ask you that. First and 20. Kurt Panky is over on the side. Here's Dickerson. They said he hadn't broken a long one. He almost broke a very long one. And they got a first down. Panky, the word is that the reason Duval Love is playing is that Panky has a cramp in his left leg. Rams take a timeout. They have only one remaining. It's 13-0 Redskins.
I've tried it. Now I believe it. Denerex Tingles tells me it's doing more. Head and shoulders, no tingle.
Both have dandruff medicine, but Denerex adds both an extra anti-itch medicine and conditioner, too.
Goodbye, head and shoulders. Hello, Denerex.
If you swallow a cold pill for your stuffed nose, you have to wait for it to travel all through your body before it gets to your nose. But Dristan long-lasting nasal spray gives you fast relief right on the nose.
Washington 13, the Rams nothing.
Let's watch that last play. I tell you, they get this guy in this tackle pulling. Boom here, and Dickerson gets in behind. But watch the block of Slater, the right tackle. See the guard, Hera, pulls. He gets a good kick out. There's Slater. He just gets a little rub off there on Olkowitz, and that's enough for a big play by Dickerson.
Comes away from it. Pass downfield for Ellard, incomplete. Coming up at the half, Brent Musburger and the head coach of the New York Giants, Bill Parcells, with highlights of the Kansas City-New York Jet game. And they'll also be talking to the winning coach, Joe Walton, of the Jets. Irv and Will will have a live report from here at RFK Stadium. That's all coming up at the half.
Of course, Dexter Manley's in hot water with this team.
He
missed practice the other day and didn't know yesterday whether he was going to play or not, or suspended him. They fined him $1,000. Didn't practice on Friday. Came back and practiced yesterday. Told everyone he was sorry.
25 seconds remaining.
78 offense.
Jackie Slater, the right offensive tackle for the Rams, jumped early. Walk off another one against Los Angeles. Seven times they've been penalized for 73 yards. That's hard to overcome.
Yeah, the Rams they're not a good enough team yet that they can overcome those types of things. Penalties and turnovers.
Second down, Everett back to throw. Almost picked off. Wilburn is number 45. Kevin House was the intended receiver. Clock stopped now with 19 seconds remaining first half.
You know, it has to be a good battle. We talked about earlier is Henry Ellard, who's a leading receiver of the Rams, going against Darryl Green. I don't think that Ellard has caught a pass yet. I don't think they've thrown one to him. So I have to say that Darryl Green is kind of putting a blanket on him. He was the leading receiver on the Rams team and didn't catch his first pass till the 10th game.
Well, he held out all that time.
time out. They want to get one shot at it. Remember the rule here. They can go for a block. They can also fair catch it. Then if they fair catch it, they can get a free kick. Now, they got a guy, Cox, that can kick the ball. Joe Gibbs was saying he's been kicking him 60, 62 yards in practice constantly. Of course, unless it's a real short kick, I don't think they'd have a chance to do that.
With only 10 seconds remaining, it wouldn't seem that they would. 13-0, Redskins leading the Rams. Next Saturday here on CBS, the playoffs continue. And, of course, Soldier Field, the Redskins or the 49ers at Chicago, Saturday at 3:30 Eastern Time. Sunday, Coach Madden and I will move up to that location, Giants Stadium. And either the Rams or the 49ers will face the Giants. Next Sunday at noon, it starts with the NFL Today.
You know, the interesting thing, Bill Parcells is in the studio down there, or up there in New York. I wonder who he's been working against this week.
Both, I guarantee it. Redskins put the punt block team in action. That should be the last play of the first half. 1 second showing on the scoreboard clock. The punt was 32 yards. No return by Curtis Jordan, I believe, who was deep. And then I have to beg your pardon. It was not Curtis Jordan. Henry Ellard was the first man down. Eric Yarber was the punt returner.
Well, we saw him practice this play that they have to run here. They're going to run that last ditch play where they put three guys on one side. They did it yesterday, putting them all out in the left,
right,
just like they're doing now, and they just threw the ball as far as he could.
And he can throw it a long way. Back goes Schrader. As far as he can. Almost touchdown. Almost worked. Art Monk. Ooh.
Hey, Schrader can throw it. Monk can usually catch it. The Rams can't let anyone get behind you in the end zone. They let two Redskins get behind them. Three Redskins behind them. Could very easily have been a touchdown.
Very easily. You are so right. That's the end of the first half with the score. The Redskins 13, the Rams nothing.
CBS Sports coverage of the National Football League is sponsored by Subaru and the Subaru XT, the Sport Magazine Super Bowl MVP Award. Federal Express, why fool around with anyone else? And by McDonald's, it's a good time for the great taste of McDonald's.
Amway presents the Walter Cronkite America's Cup Report.
John Bertrand was the skipper who won the America's Cup for Australia in 1983. John, how does a young man ever get on the ladder to eventually be selected as an America's Cup helmsman?
Well, really, the training ground is Olympic Games and World Championship competition. And what we're looking for with these America's Cup teams are the very best people in the country. And hopefully, they will have Olympic Games experience under their belt. All those, we're looking for the very best people we can get.
John, is the America's Cup among sailors really the holy grail?
I think, Walter, it's probably about four or five Olympic Games rolled into one, so you can't go any higher than the America's Cup, that's right. So you need two teams going out, one skipper versus another. Eventually, it's an eyeball-to-eyeball confrontation.
Some people are as reliable as sunrise. You can see it in their smile, feel it in their handshake. Their life is fulfilling. Is rewarding. Happiness is something they've created for themselves. Amway people. Hardworking Americans you can rely on to give their best. Every day.
Welcome back to New York. I'm Brett Musburger along with Bill Parcells, the coach of the New York Giants. And Bill, John Madden raised the question, Who has the coaching staff been working on this week, the Los Angeles Rams or the San Francisco 49ers?
Well, we've been doing a little of both, Brent. And in our practice, we've incorporated some of both teams and trying to get ready.
All right, there was a controversy, the first one of the playoffs, involving instant replay. In case you just joined us, it was this pass play by the Rams, Everett to Hill, Coleman over, knocks the ball down. Bill, what did you think? Was it a fumble?
Well, I don't know, Brent. I think that no matter what it was, it shouldn't take 5 minutes to decide. The intent of the thing was obvious, and if it's obvious, it should take less than 5 minutes.
Well, here was the replay that finally caused them to determine that it was a fumble, that the ball was stripped by Hill. Bill, let me ask you your feeling about instant replay, period. Should we be using it to change calls such as that?
Yes, I think so. I think anything that will assist in the officiating the coaches are for. I think it needs a little work, however.
Well, exactly, because as you could see, the fumble was ruled, and it went over to the Washington Redskins in that situation. And as a result of the three turnovers, the Redskins lead the Rams at the half 13-0. Out at RFK Stadium, Bill, Irv Cross is standing by, and he's close to the Redskins locker room. Irv?
You know, Brett, before I talk about what's going on in here, you know, I was standing right on the sideline right next to the play when the ball was fumbled. And I think what the officials saw, and what I saw and felt, and, this, and Coach Parcells will tell you this, you get a feeling for the game, the knee was down, it was like a bang-bang ball, you know, so it looked like the play was dead, then the ball came out. But after seeing that replay from the end zone, you could actually see the ball dropping out before his knee hit the ground. So maybe the instant replay is the way to go. At least that angle showed that that call was a correct call to make on the replay judgment. But in any case, one of the things that Coach Gibbs wanted to do is increase the intensity level of his football team. For the last few weeks, he's been stressing the fact that he should take the ball away. Now, in the first half, they've taken the ball away three times from the Rams, shutting off Rams scoring opportunities and setting up opportunities for themselves. The intensity level is high. They feel good about their first half of play. As a matter of fact, as the players are coming down the tunnel, they said, hey, keep it up, keep it up, keep it up. 30 more minutes. Brent?
All right, Irv. And Bill, another coach was concerned about his ball club, and that was Joe Walton of the New York Jets. And earlier today in the AFC wildcard game, the Jets exploded, and they eliminated the Kansas City Chiefs, and they did it with a new quarterback. Pat Ryan replaced Kenny O'Brien and led the Jets to victory. Bill, you were out there. What about this quarterback draw on 4th and 6?
Well, the Kansas City was in a nickel defense, Brent, man-to-man, and they have no one assigned to the quarterback, and it was a heck of a call by the Jet coaching staff.
What'd you feel about Walton changing to Ryan in this particular instance?
Well, I think he was looking for something to give his team some impetus, and obviously it did.
Now, would you stick with Ryan next week against Cleveland?
Oh, I think based on what he saw today that he'll probably do that, yes.
Well, Ryan stepped in there, and along with that quarterback draw, he also chucked 3 touchdown passes. Key moment was the start of the second half. Blackledge was trying to rally the Chiefs. It was picked off by Kevin MacArthur, and he ran it in. Short time ago, I asked Joe Walton about the tremendous burden that had been lifted from the shoulders of the Jet coaching staff.
Well, we feel very good about it, that we were able to get the players back and play a good game. One of the things you try to do in this league, there's 28 teams that try to get in the playoffs, and we made it. We feel that we earned it. We start a new season today, and we're 1-0, so we feel good about that.
What did Pat Ryan mean to this victory for the Jets?
Well, he gave us a tremendous lift on offense. He's a quality kid. He's a guy that I trust. I think I have two good quarterbacks, and two guys that can play and win, and we needed a little lift, and Pat came in and gave it to us.
Joe, what did Ken O'Brien feel like when you told him that he was going to be taken down today? What was his reaction?
Well, you know, when that happens, you're always disappointed, and I think he was, but I think he's a real team player, and he and Pat have a great relationship, and he rooted for Pat and helped all week, and he helped during the game today, and I'm proud of him for the way he's handled it.
And you'll stick with Ryan as a starter against Cleveland next week?
I'm not sure what I'm going to do yet. We'll make that decision later. I might change my mind if I said something now anyway.
All right, Joe, what about the Browns? What concerns you with that ball club?
Well, they're an excellent football team. They're probably playing the best of anybody in the AFC right now. I haven't really studied them that close yet. I'll start tomorrow morning looking at them, but I know they're playing good football.
All right, Joe, congratulations and thank you.
Oh, you're welcome, Brett.
Bill, I know you've been concentrating on the NFC, but what about the Jets versus the Cleveland Browns next Saturday?
Well, I agree with Joe. I think Cleveland's playing very well, and Cleveland's a very tough place to play this time of year, and I think it's going to take a good effort by the Jets to get it done.
All right. We're going to come back and talk about the Giants, Mike Ditka's team to beat in the playoffs, and we'll do that right after these messages from your local stations.
Mitsubishi. My brother needed a new truck. I told him Mitsubishi Mighty Max is Chrysler and Toyota.
Nissan or Mazda. Then Sis wanted one with extras. Mighty Max Sport, I said. Next, I said, before you buy, test drive a Mitsubishi. They'll give you $100. You'll even get the $100 if you buy somebody else's new 87 import. That got him.
Hurry, you must test drive and purchase by January 4th. Plus, special factory incentives could mean a better deal.
Wednesday, Mike's looking for a missing sister.
Deirdre is dead, or is she?
We all make mistakes.
Then on Magnum.
My sister is out there somewhere.
She was skimming from a man.
One tough customer.
You're beginning to annoy me.
It could get worse.
Then.
If you go to the police, you'll be killed.
What do these guys want from me?
I intend to find out.
The Equalizer, all Wednesday.
Live from New York, join host Gladys Knight and the Pips with Glenn Campbell, Frank Musburger, and from Disney World, Air Supply, Freddie Jackson, and Melba Moore. CBS's Happy New Year, America.
This is CBS.
This commercial is an opportunity for those of you who haven't seen the latest Saab, the 9000, to finally get a good look at one. Time's up.
Test drive the new Saab 9000S automatic at your local Saab dealer.
In New York, the country's Big Apple. The word around town is German.
Beck's.
In Washington, the nation's capital, the word around town is German.
Beck's.
In Los Angeles, the home of the stars, the word around town is German.
Beck's.
Beck's, the number one imported German beer.
Closed for the night. Everyone gone. No more business today. But through the magic of our public data network, now you and your customers can do business 24 hours a day. At Bell Atlantic, we open new doors in communications, and providing you with the tools you need to compete is just the beginning. Our real genius lies in the way we manage those technologies to give you that competitive edge. The companies of Bell Atlantic, we make technology work for you.
You'll flip over Warner Wolf's Plays of the Year, Saturday.
Bill, here we have another home team with a lead. The Giants have the home field all the way. Why is it so important in the playoffs? I think 70% of the time the home teams win in a playoff game in the NFL.
Well, I think it has more to do with the routine, Brent. You know, your players at home, they're in the routine, they're used to doing the same things, and it's just a little more positive atmosphere.
Do you think the Rams could come back in the second half in RFK?
Oh, yes, I do. I think they're lucky to be only down 13-0 now, and I think that's probably the way they'll look at it. They still have a chance to win it.
All right. Let's go out now to the Ram locker room. Will McDonough is standing by in RFK. And, Will, I know you've been talking to some of the coaches, and you've got one of the defensive men with you.
Yeah, Brent, I've got Fritz Sherman, the defensive coordinator of the Rams, with me. Fritz, he was kind of loud in there at the halftime. Everybody in the country thinks you guys are going to die because it's 13-0. Seemed like they were more angry than anything else.
Yeah, I think it's pretty obvious, and John reminded them that most of what's happened to us, we have done ourselves. We committed the turnovers and had a couple of crucial penalties in there, Will, which caused us to play football on a short field, and nobody plays very well there. We just need to go out and not help them, and I think we're confident we go out there and play a great second half, and we have a great chance to win a ball game.
It looks like you're going to have to come out of your game plan. You've been very conservative both sides of the ball in the first half. Now to get back, it looks like you're going to have to blitz more, and your offense is going to have to throw more.
Well, I think there's some critical third and possession down situations, 3rd and 6, where we've been zoning, making a play underneath, but we may have to change up with a little man in there and knock him out. We've been pretty good at what we do, but we just can't do it on a short field. So the penalties and the turnovers and those kinds of things, we need to turn around the other way.
Fritz, thanks very much for coming by. A tough time. Now back upstairs to Pat and John.
All right, Will, you look at the situation that was just discussed downstairs outside the Ram locker room. Jim Everett, a young quarterback, hasn't been in a situation like this, has to come behind, has to bring the Rams from behind. What sort of temperament must he have to get in that situation, to get him out of it?
They look, and as they were just saying, as Fritz Sherman just said and John Robinson said, and really, the Redskins haven't done as much to us as we've done to ourselves. So if we don't do those things to ourselves, and then if we can just take advantage of some good things, we can get back. I think that the Rams have to feel pretty good, if they have anything to feel good about, right, is the fact that they've had so many bad things happen to them, and they're only down 13-0. And as I said in there, if we can score three touchdowns, we can win this thing.
Well, let's look statistically at what has happened to the Rams and see how they've turned. The Redskins lead 13-0. You can't get away from that. But look at what's happened with turnovers, and we've talked about that so many times.
Well, that's the big thing. I think when you get teams like this, and they're so evenly matched, that things like turnovers are going to make the difference. Now, in the first half, the Rams had three turnovers. The Redskins didn't. Then from those turnovers, where the Rams gave to the Redskins have 6 points out of those turnovers. So that's really been the story of the first half.
And another half to go. And CBS Sports coverage of NFL football will continue after this message and a word from your local station.
Sports presents the champions, the people, and the events that make dreams come true. When you look for champions, you look to CBS Sports.
Imagine the power of two great computer companies coming together as one. Resources not just doubled, but raised to the power of two. Introducing Unisys. True competition in the computer industry, and a single winner will emerge. You.
This high-performance drink cleans your fuel system to help maintain peak performance. STP Gas Treatment, the high-performance drink for your car.
Asia after 60,000 miles, Europe after 40,000, continental U.S. only 20,000 miles. Look whose frequent flyer program serves up the world faster.
This is an AT&T Long Distance Command Center where our engineers make sure your calls go right through. It's a unique system only AT&T can bring you, with thousands of ways to get from here to there. And there are seven more centers like it, because we're not about to take chances that busy circuits could keep you waiting.
Well, she definitely has my hair.
For over 100 years, when you reached out, we were there. And you can keep it that way. AT&T, the right choice.
No Mercy delivers breathless action with style and energy, says Roger Ebert. And Jeffrey Lyons, sneak previews calls it a sizzler. Gear and Basinger are on fire. No Mercy, rated R.
Crazy Eddie loves Christmas so much, he doesn't want it to end.
So it won't! Crazy Eddie's still celebrating Christmas with blowout blitz sale prices are insane!
Cats, the number one musical in America. The world's most thrilling theatrical event. Cats at the Winter Garden Theater. Call 239-6200 for tickets.
CBS Sports coverage of the National Football League is sponsored by Bud Light. Everything else is just a light. General Electric. At GE, we bring good things to life. And by Toyota, builder of tough, powerful, reliable trucks, Toyota.
CBS Sports bringing you the playoffs in the NFL. 1986. As we near the end of the season, and certainly nearer the end for one of these two teams, as the Redskins lead the Rams 13-0 in the NFC wild card game. getting ready for the start of the third quarter. Pat Summerall and John Madden, the two big backs we talked about, and that's what they did in the first half.
Well, you know, you look at that thing, and it's about as even as you can get, except for the one thing, that last one. Dickerson has fumbled twice. Rodgers has not fumbled, and that's the difference in the first half in the score.
And the Rams lost both of those Dickerson fumbles. They lost one more. Kickoff headed in the direction of Garner. Out he comes and cut down at about the 22. Jay Schrader, who likes to go upfield, no matter what the defense.
Well, I'll tell you, you know, against this Ram defense, you can see he stayed in that short area, 8 for 9, under 10, between 10 and 20, 2 for 3, and over 20 yards, he hasn't completed a pass yet.
And that's just very much against his nature, because he likes to go upfield.
You know, and I think that this game calls for a little patience by Jay Schrader, and I think he's shown that in the first half.
Off Monk as he started to look upfield before he had the ball. Jerry Gray was the nearest defender.
And Jerry Gray expected that it could have bounced right into Gray's hands because it comes out of Monk's hands and goes forward. As he starts to turn, it goes right by Gray. Gray was zeroed in on Monk, not watching the ball.
Second and 10. Jerry Gray. Started, he had no idea that he'd be in that situation. Second down, 10, they give to Kelvin Bryant. He gets around the corner. Out of bounds after a gain of about 6. Nolan Crumwell and Jerry Gray both there. Maybe not 6, maybe about 3.
Now, Kelvin Bryant is one of those guys that is a great runner, but because the Redskins have used him so much as a pass receiver, you kind of forget his running ability. You know, he's not that big, strong running back you think of. He's kind of that, kind of more skinny, angular guy.
Third and 7, I just wondered if something might be wrong with Rodgers. Remember, we saw him in the first half with his thumb being taped. Schrader back to throw. Has time. Incomplete. Flags fly from every place.
That one has to be a couple of penalties in there because there were 3 flags coming from 3 different directions.
Do you refuse it?
Well, I can't believe they all got the same guy on that one. Yeah, I would think that I would refuse it because here you are, you're down 13 to nothing. You're going to get
number 66 on the offense. Penalty decline, fourth down.
You're going to get good field position anyway. You want to get the ball and start making something happen offensively.
Jacoby, the culprit. That's Henry Ellard, number 80. Steve Cox back deep to punt for the Redskins. As far as field position is concerned, Todd Bowles on the stop. But Eller gets him back close to midfielder. Pankey back in after that cramp that put him on the sidelines in the first half. New Year's Day here on CBS. Ohio State against Texas A&M. Starts at 1:30 Eastern Time. The Big Ten against the Southwest. Into Redskin territory for a gain of about 7. Alvin Walton and Curtis Jordan had to make the stop, the 2 safety men.
You know, here's the play that we were talking about, and it's going to be keyed on the guy in the top of the screen there. As Dickerson gets the ball here, if man number 71 starts out or goes up like he did, Dickerson is going to cut it in. So he's getting the ball, and he's looking right at 71. Of course, 71 went on his back that time, didn't he?
Dickerson, as the Redskins came on a wild blitz with Curtis Jordan, went right past everybody and picked up another 8. Ooh, that could have been gone.
that's the type of thing that you do. I mean, you can see that, they're going to blitz. They're bringing their safeties up. Now watch, here comes Jordan up. He's going to blitz there. The center picks him off. Dickerson went to the other side.
First down, Rams inside the Redskin 40. That's Barry Redden going the other way. And here's Dickerson rolling and bouncing off people down to about the 33. He got five before Vernon Dean finally put him down.
I think Dickerson had a little meeting with himself at halftime. They said, you know, I went out there the first half, I fumbled twice. I'm the guy on this team. I'm the guy. If we're going to win, I have to do well. I have to make yardage. I can't be fumbling. I can't be doing those types of things. I'm going to come out and show why I'm a superstar.
When he carries the ball more than 29 times since he's been there, the Rams have never lost. Ever. Nothing there. House, the intended receiver.
Somewhere, the Rams have to do a little of that. They've only completed one pass to an outside receiver, and that was to Kevin House. They have yet to complete one to Henry Ellard, nor have they thrown one. There's Bruce Snyder giving the signals now. That guy that was giving the signals there is the new head coach at the University of California.
Right. But staying here as long as the playoffs last. Third and five, big down. Redskins again showing blitz to Redden. Not sure. Juggling maybe. Could be incomplete.
Yeah, they said out of bounds. The official over on that side signals out of bounds. Everett had to get rid of that ball. He just threw it out there. Yep. Juggling. He didn't have control of the ball. A pretty good throw by Everett, though, because he had a big rush on him.
Backpedaling like that. Here's the field goal attempt coming up. Steve Dills holding. Lansford for the field goal, 51 yards out. Not sure on a cold day like this he can get it there. That might be there. But it's wide right. And they'll bring it back to that line of scrimmage. And so the Redskins hold off the Rams and still lead 13-0.
Don't just ask for a light.
Can I have a light?
Ask them to bring out their best.
Bud Light?
Bud Light. A less filling light beer with a first name and taste. Because everything else is just a light.
Firefly.
Here at Hewlett-Packard, we think long and hard about your business computing system and how it can help your people share more information and make better decisions. So before we talk hardware, we answer a lot of hard questions. At Hewlett-Packard, we never stop asking, what if?
They need a network package between sales and shipping. What if we took a new approach to the problem? The way I see it,
for you with a Toyota 4x4. You can feel good about the power, feel terrific about the performance, sensational about the price.
Looking out for number one.
Right now, your Toyota dealer is looking out for you by passing along factory-to-dealer incentives so you can save even more money on Toyota trucks. Who could ask for anything more?
Don't just ask for a light beer.
Give me a light.
Ask them to bring out their best.
Bud Light.
Bud Light. The less filling light beer with a first name and taste. Because everything else.
The dining car.
It's just a light.
NFC Divisional Playoff. Saturday, 3:30 Eastern Standard Time. Either the Redskins or the 49ers. At Chicago. It's one of those lookout teams, those Bears. And on Sunday, look out for the Giants against either the Rams or the 49ers. At 12 Eastern, that's when it begins with the NFL Today.
I wonder who Bill Parcells was looking out for.
Been looking out for his own Giants this year, and he's been looking out pretty well.
And I bet he's looking out for the 49ers. If I were a betting man.
Which, of course, you're not. That's Rodgers back in the game, and Rodgers into the Rams secondary. Cut down after a gain of about 9.5, 10. Nolan
Cromwell. That might be enough. As a matter of fact, for a Redskin first down, they're going to measure.
This one, they start with a motion, I formation. Again, Don Warren, the tight end, in the backfield, getting a lead block, straight up the middle, boom, with the big tailback. I think that's the type of thing that you want to do. You want to take the guy, take your offensive line, get in behind him, get the movement going, wear down the defense, pick up the first down, and control the game.
12-18 left in the third quarter. Redskins leading 13-0. And the clock running. That's what they like to do with it right now. Monk goes wide to the left. Clark comes to the right. Doubt about whether he'd play, but Clark has been there the whole time. Didier is the move man. Now Warren moves over to the left behind him. Sign of trouble.
Well, you know, that middle is doing a good job. You know, that Jeff Bostic, Russ Grimm, R.C. Thielman. Watch the center and both guards there. You see Thielman come out on the linebacker there, get a little movement there. Rodgers is able to get in behind him and cut off that block. You know, they're running off the nose tackle in there at the bubble that the linebackers create.
Second down, same formation, except Warren stays. Got six.
Hey, this Redskin team and this type of blocking reminds me of the Redskins teams that went to the Super Bowls. Watch them take off. Watch Jacoby up there, 66 on Dawg. Get him going back. Get him going back. Just push him off. They're just knocking him off the line on that left side over there.
Next stop, Chicago. And it looks more and more like that might happen. Rodgers with 74 yards down. The Redskins hammering on the ground. Again, left side. Again, good yardage, but penalty markers come flying. Clark might have moved early.
Watch Joe Jacoby here on the end of the line. Let me, I'll circle him here so you can watch him. Watch how he gets in underneath and then roots up on Reggie Dawg. A big, tall guy, like 6'7". Watch him get underneath. You see, and then root him up. See, root him up, 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 up. They get him turned. And then the back goes right through there.
There's the penalty.
That should never happen. That's just out there. Gary Clark, again, he hasn't been practicing with the team. And those little things, you can't do those perfectly without practicing.
Bryant has replaced Rodgers. Face belongs to Dave Butts, and that helmet has been used a few times.
And if the Redskins win, his son will be down there to carry that helmet off the field.
Boy, he's got a strong son.
Yeah, but I mean, those are nicks in there. Those aren't just little like scratches.
No.
I mean, those are where you go in and you dig stuff out and throw it off.
That helmet looks like it's been through the 4th of July.
It looks like he wrestled with that thing. Jay Schrader. Here's a guy only in his second year as a starter. He played about a half a year, started a half a year last year when Joe Theismann went down, started all this year. But when you see him, he's like a kid. I mean, he has a team, like he's enjoying himself, and this, it's a game to him, and it's fun, and everyone's, you know, a friend, and you just go out there and play the game. Nothing seems to upset this guy.
To us, he is a kid.
Yeah, that's right.
Third down. They need 13. Fine.
Vince Newsom are up in a hurry. Punting team on. The Redskins took some time off the clock, which now leading 13-0 is very important to them. Redskins take their time. Steve Cox in the punt. And back deep for the Rams, Henry Eller. High kick. Johnny Johnson signals fair catch and makes it. He was back there with Eller. Only a 28-yard kick by Cox. And so the Rams take over.
Introducing the limited edition Toyota trucks. They're loaded with extras, but you save money. Save on a chrome package. Save on sport striping. Save on sporty wheels, a chrome step bumper. Save up to $723. Save on a deluxe interior, AM/FM with cassette. And with Toyota special factory to dealer incentives, you could save even more. Toyota, looking out for you by saving you money.
We stay as new as you do, so you can live the way you want to. We know the way you love to live. We're GE, and this is what we give. We give you time to give the children time to let them see the light. It lights their life, the light that sees you through.
Southwest Conference winner Texas A&M battles Big Ten co-champion Ohio State in the 51st annual Cotton Bowl Classic, New Year's Day on CBS Sports.
Wild card playoff game, Rams-Redskins, with Washington leading 13-0.
We can see that Everett has spread the ball around. He's 2 for 4 under 10, 2 for 4, 10 to 20, 0 for 2 in the 20 to 30. Nothing in the 30 to 40, and then one for one, that big one that he hit Kevin House on. I think his problem is he hasn't been able, other than one time, to get the ball to a wide receiver.
The Redskins have done a lot of blitzing, a lot of different blitzing schemes. They hope to confuse him, and maybe they have. First down, Everett back to throw. In the arms of Charles Mann, the first sack of the day.
Well, it's an interesting thing. Charles Mann got off to the best start of this Redskin defensive line. Then he injured a knee, and Manley came on and had a big year. But Mann, I think, is going to be the future star in this defensive line of the Redskins. Hey, he just went right by Jackie Slater.
20. Dickerson standing in the end zone, but they give it to Redden. He comes out and is really hit by Alvin Walton. This guy, number 40, remember that name.
Yeah, you talk about a de-cleater. When Walton hits him, those cleats go out of the ground.
Steve Bartkowski over on the Ram bench.
You know, John Robinson said last night that Bartkowski had a great week in practice. He says, if Everett struggles during this game, I won't hesitate to go to Bartkowski in the second half.
That might be soon. Third and 16 they face right now. Movement and penalty markers come down.
I think Charles Mann is maybe a little quicker than Jackie Slater thought. And Slater tried to get a jump on him, and he moved before the ball was snapped. Those guys, you know, great defensive players not
Pace
only make
back,
plays.
Number 78 offense, still third down.
But they caused the other side to make penalties. This happens when a Charles Mann is going well. It happens when a Manly is going well. You see it a lot on a Lawrence Taylor. Guys trying to block and are always getting going before the ball snaps.
Well, we saw it happen earlier in the year, midway, when Dallas played in New York and George Martin did such a number. Here's Dickerson. Dickerson gets maybe to the five and the Rams will have to punt. Only a gain of two. And Monty Coleman put the clamp on Eric Dickerson along with Rich Mullott.
The emotional tide is high on this Redskin team right now.
Eric Yarber, number 80, goes back deep for the Redskins. Catcher with his back to you and his back to the back of the end zone. We'll punt for the Rams. The 46 is Yarber. Struggling and finally is down at about the 40. The Redskins in good shape with 6:28 left in the third quarter and still leading 13 to nothing. A 41-yard punt by Hatcher.
For you with a powerful new Toyota 4Runner. Four-wheel drive, room for five, and an unlimited capacity for excitement.
Looking out for number one.
Looking out for you has made the Toyota 4Runner number one in owner satisfaction. Who could ask for anything more?
Came in on a cool wave from Australia. Refreshing as a plunge into the icy surf. Lighter alcohol beer takes on a blazing sun and a dusty thirst. And it's brewed in America. LA beer from Anheuser-Busch. The cool way to kill a hot thirst.
Nowadays, when it comes to telecommunications, there's a great deal of confusion. With so many different products and services available, it's a real problem knowing what's just right for your company. Well, we have a way to end that confusion and solve those problems. We can help custom tailor an entire telecommunications system to your company's exact needs. Know GTE.
The ever-excited Bobby Knight leads the All-America finesse of Steve Alford and the Indiana Hoosiers against the Buckeyes of Ohio State Sunday on CBS Sports.
You know, John, when you talk about, as we do on Saturday, to both coaches and players and what have you, things rarely work out like they hope. But I think for the Redskins, today, things really have.
Well, it's just what they wanted to do. They wanted to be able to get the ball, not have to force things, not have Schrader have to throw the ball, get a running game going, control it with their offensive line, and smother and tackle with their defense. Now, that's a big thing I think they've done. They've really smothered this Ram team.
They really have. They've been pretty much in control from the beginning. They took advantage of the opportunities that they got from those Ram turnovers, and they lead it 13-0. They give to Rodgers, and Rodgers cuts over the middle, got a couple. Sean Miller made the stop. The Ram bench, Jackie Slater, the offensive unit. They've had a tough time.
Well, there's Dennis Herron, number 60, and Jackie Slater. They're both the right side of that Ram offensive line. Guys going to the Pro Bowl, but they really haven't been able to get it started today and get control of it. And I think, as I said earlier, I think the Redskins have gotten control of them.
Second and eight. Redskins have the ball, Ram 37. Ricky Sanders split wide to the right. They give again to Rodgers. And again, Rodgers barreling straight ahead. Mel Owens and Mark Giroux. Rodgers got five, and it was a tough, hard five by George Rodgers.
Well, it was. He finished off a run. You know, I mean, they had those hogs in there kind of rooting out. You know, you get the hogs in front, and they root, 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 and then you get George Rodgers come in there, and he finishes off the root. But watch him there. They all get going, double-teaming the nose tackle, kick out by Warren. Now watch how you finish out the root. You see, you just get your left shoulder down and boom, and come right up through on a roof.
Good block by Russ Grimm. Brand replaced Roger. Schrader outside Sanders. Driven backwards, but he got the first down. A gain of five. Johnny Johnson, the defender, but they'll move the markers.
This really isn't Jay Schrader's type of game. But Jay Schrader is playing with discipline and patience that you have to play against a Ram defense.
Because of their zone philosophy.
That's right. I mean, you can't go for the big ones. You can't let them get you off balance. You just have to nickel and dime them.
Sanders goes wide to the left this time, and Monk is split out of your picture to the right. That's Zinnier. On the move. Schrader fakes. Fires to Monk. Interesting Joe Gibbs comment yesterday when we were doing our regular ritual. You said, what about Art Monk? And he said, Art Monk is Art Monk.
And I think of all the guys, if Joe Gibbs has a favorite player, I think it's Art Monk. I mean, he's the type, first guy out at practice, last guy to leave, never miss a practice, never miss a game, never miss a play. You know, if there's such a thing as Mr. Dependable, that's Art Monk.
Left side to about just short of the 20. Stopped by Mike Wilcher, but a gain of three.
Russ Grimm is raising his hand coming out of the game. Looks like he pulled something. Now he says, I'll stay in here. A guy like Russ, he'll just rub some dirt on some of that stuff. You get some combinations up in there, something, you just kind of rub some mud on it. No one even watches those old guards. And Russ is that kind of player. I mean, he's an old-fashioned guy. He just prop him up and play him.
Third and three, and the Redskins decide, hey, wait a minute. Let's have a look at some people. And they call a timeout. Schrader comes over to the sideline. 3:05 left in the third quarter.
Giving that extra effort makes winners. Be all you can be. Sponsored by the U.S. Army. A key factor in the Redskins' drive to the playoffs has been number 84, Gary Clark. The 5'9" receiver is the quintessential overachiever, a small player who often beats much larger defenders through sheer hustle and extra effort. By working hard to become Washington's premier receiver in just his second NFL season, Gary Clark is the best he can be.
Light Fighters, the new light infantry. No matter where you are, in the jungle, the Arctic, the desert, or the mountains, you run out of day before you run out of challenge.
You know, all this talk about building your confidence might sound like a lot of hype. Let me tell you, hype doesn't get you to the top of this rock.
Be all that you can be.
Hey, Gal.
What?
The elevator's here.
Find your future in the Army.
On our way back to Pat and John, let me remind everybody that on New Year's Day, Thursday afternoon, the Cotton Bowl from Dallas, Ohio State against Texas A&M. The Aggies quarterback Kevin Murray announced today that he will be back as a senior next year, and that should be a high-scoring Cotton Bowl coming up on Thursday. Bill Parcells, what about your thoughts on the Rams and the Redskins here in the third quarter now of the wild card game?
Well, Brett, their Redskins are playing exactly the way they want to now. They're not taking any chances, and if the Rams don't get something going pretty soon, the clock's really going to start working against them.
All right, Bill, let's send it back now to Pat Summerall and John Madden. Pat?
All right, Brent, thank you. As Russ Grimm heads for the Redskin locker room, it appeared, I know he'd had some neck and back and nerve problems early in the year. That looked like some sort of a leg or ankle injury.
I think Russ Grimm has had entire body this year. I mean, as you said, he's had the neck and the back, and I think he's had both legs. And now we see Riley McKenzie is in there replacing him.
He'll be next to Jacoby on the left side. Third down. That's Kelvin Bryant on the move. Schrader back quickly fires. Clark incomplete. And we'll have another look at Jess Atkinson. Johnny Johnson was the defender. That Ram defense has been on the field an awful long time today. And the fact
fact that they've only given up 13 points, I think, is a pretty good tribute to them.
Well, they've done a good job of holding the Redskins off, but they haven't been able to get the ball back. You know, they haven't been able to take it away. They haven't been able to get that good field position, and they think the Redskins have been just wearing them down.
Atkinson this time from 28 yards, 38 yards, Megan. He's hit two. He hit another one. 16-0. Redskins over the Rams.
You know, it's funny, yeah, the Redskins have had three kickers this year with Atkinson being the third guy. They had him in training camp. They waived him. And then they brought him back. He still remembers how to give those low fives. But a guy sitting around is on the street. They played against Denver. The guy doesn't kick any. They bring in this guy. He lives in the area. Bring him back. Now this guy's kicking in playoff games. And these are the guys that always loom big. You know, we make fun of kickers. They do this. They're lonely. They got all these things. But when the big games come, it's always one of these guys that are going to win it or lose it. But whatever they do, they don't have a lot of friends. A lot of people don't listen to them, but they have a lot of explanations for what they're doing.
Well, that's part of being a kicker. I mean, you got to have the excuses in one column. You got to have somebody to blame in another column. And you got to have your friends in another column.
And then you have
there aren't many of those.
Atkinson was giving it a two-hand. He was giving it a right-handed and a left-handed like this. Like this he was going.
Most important thing if you're a kicker is to find somebody to blame.
I'll tell you one thing. You're talking about blaming. You showed me that letter that he wrote to the editor of the Washington Post defending his college coach, Bobby Ross, and the Maryland program.
White has it bounce off his hands. Cox's kickoff it is, and puts the Rams in another deep hole. So,
okay, that's the kind of day it is for these guys.
All right. The last time they were here in a playoff game, the score was 51-7, I think. Today it's 16-0, and nothing good has happened. Here comes Everett back in. I thought he might go to Barkowski. Not that Everett's done that bad a job.
Redskins have jumped on top and smothered them. Kept that bag over their head all day, and whoever you put a quarterback isn't going to change that, at least in this position.
2:52 left, third quarter. Dickerson. And Dickerson gives him some breathing room. Picks up 11 before Dexter Manley tripped him up with help from Curtis Jordan. But they move the first down yard. Eric Dickerson, 18 times, 82 yards. The key statistic on him today, without degrading his great talent, is those two fumbles. Are those two fumbles? Redden, outside the 20. Gain of 5. Manley again. John Robinson. He said, we've got to go back. Start to do again what we do best, and that's run it.
Yeah, but it's hard to do when you get down 16-0 and you're getting towards the end of the third quarter.
Second and 5, Dickerson again. Dickerson comes. Good night. Somebody's going to have to really run. It's going to be Darryl Green from behind. Dickerson down at the 15. I didn't think anybody would catch him when he came out of the pack like that.
I'll tell you, except Darryl Green. Darryl Green is the fastest guy in the NFL, and he proved it there. That was a great race. That was like watching the 100-yard dash in the Olympics or something. Watch here. Dickerson breaks through. He's out in the open. There's no one there. Watch 28 from behind. That is a great football play. I mean, Darryl Green is in the Pro Bowl, but if he weren't, just on that play alone, he should be.
And that illustrates to you why he has that mantle. The fastest guy around. Here's Dickerson inside the 15. Manley again on the bottom. is quicker than that.
Daryl Green is still trying to get the oxygen back, though. And I'll tell you, not only that play, but Daryl Green has done a heck of a job on Ellard. The number one receiver of the Rams has yet to catch a pass, and Daryl Green has been on him all day.
Second and nine. Rams go with a two tight end setup. Johnson and Hill make give to Dickerson, looking for some room. He gets a little bit. Down to about the 11. That'll bring up a third down package. Only two. Again, Manley. Clock running now. That would be to the end of the third quarter, down to 5 seconds. Everett walking over to the bench, and the Rams will be content to let it run out. That's the end of the third quarter with the score Washington 16. The Rams nothing, and we now pause for a word from your local station.
This is CBS.
Eastern is the shuttle airline.
It's second nature to me to take the Eastern shuttle. Wouldn't think about using anybody else. I know there's lots of competition, but they're the people I just go to.
And I'm happy with it. And I don't think I'd go to any of the other airlines.
I think the Eastern shuttle has always been very efficient. It's become even more so with the improvements.
Improvements like snacks and beverages, roomier seating, and more comfortable terminals. The Eastern Air Shuttle Plus.
You've gone from a cab ride to closer to a limousine ride.
A new community is on the way to creation. Extraordinary in concept. In New Jersey, across the Hudson from the World Trade Center. Using New Jersey Bell's electronic switching and fiber optics to provide services like Community Centrics and integrated voice and data. This is Newport, and we are New Jersey Bell. The genius behind your first look at the 21st century.
This commercial is an opportunity for those of you who haven't seen the latest Saab, the 9000, to finally get a good look at one. Time's up.
Test drive the new Saab 9000S automatic at your local Saab dealer.
You'll flip over Warner Wolf's Plays of the Year, Saturday.
CBS Sports coverage of the National Football League is sponsored by Dodge, setting new standards of performance. Budweiser, Beechwood Aged for that clean, crisp taste. This Bud's for you. And by Hewlett-Packard, the people who turn your business computing problem into a business computing solution.
NFL on CBS, the playoffs of 1986. This is the wild card game between the Rams and the Redskins. And the Redskins lead with a quarter to play. 16-0. It's third and seven. Jim Everett looking for somebody to give it to. In the end zone. Touchdown, Kevin House. The crowd suddenly went quiet as Everett, out of the pocket, looked, searched, and finally found.
Watch him here. He has good pass protection. You see, he has a pretty good thing there. There's no one to throw to. He starts, he pumps once, he's still looking. Man is chasing him. He gets rid of it, finds House right on the corner of the goal line. Whew. I tell you, hey, that was some play for House to catch that ball, stay there, and come down with both feet in bounds.
Get it in bounds. A very, very important extra point right here. And it's good at 16-7. Just barely inbounds the touchdown. Look at this.
This was one of the big things that was a plus for the Rams this year, is getting Kevin House. Remember when he was just waived by Tampa Bay. The Rams were looking for a receiver, and they come up with this guy.
Especially with the loss of Ron Brown. Back to the run that set it up.
Of course, this is a big play. Now watch Dickerson. He's going to start in here, and he's going to break through. Here's Dickerson. He's going to start through here, and he's going to break it up in the middle. And we'll watch this run. Good block. Starts to the left. Now he's going to cut back to the right. Now, if we stop it right here, we'll see here's Darrell Green. Here's Dickerson. They're even. And the race starts here. And watch Green catch him. That is some sprint. And tackle.
That's closing some ground on a guy you know can really run. Eric Dickerson, Laverne Torgerson over in the middle of that Redskin meeting. And over on the other sideline, hey, we're not out of this thing yet. 16-7, 14-51 left to play. Fourth quarter, in game. At the 8, here comes a fake reverse. Flags go down. A return of 17. Vince Newsom made the stop. Let's check out with Irv Cross. Irv, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here, Pat. I'm here with Senator Eugene McCarthy from Minnesota. Is being considered as the director of the National Library of Congress. Are you concerned, Senator, today that perhaps more people in Washington are probably watching this football game than reading?
Well, not really. But I think that the library thing is a proposition to some people who want to get me out of politics. I'm a little skeptical of reading. Minnesota has the highest literacy rate of any state now. They've begun to vote Republican. So,
you know, Senator, last weekend in New York, one of our colleagues interviewed former President Richard Nixon. Any reaction?
Oh, I know you're getting down pretty low on the political totem pole. I think you go from Nixon to me.
Thanks for being with us. Let's go back to the game, Pat.
Thank you, Irv. 14:39 remaining. Off the right side is Rogers, and Rogers out of bounds after a gain of 8 or 9. 8, call it. Johnny Johnson chased him out. Big Joe Jacoby over on the sideline.
Well, you know, that's something. That's the left side of that Redskin line. They lost Grimm. He's out now. Now Jacoby is out. He has a broken hand. And they say that he wouldn't return unless an emergency.
Grimm, we understand. Well, I see him just walking out of the dugout right now. But he has a possible broken rib, but he may not be back. So let's check that left side of the Redskin offense. Over the right side, and it would appear that he got enough for the first down.
You know, if we look here, this is George Rogers. His first 5 carries, 26 yards. His second 5, 14. His third 5, 20 yards. Now his fourth, 24 yards. So really, he had a little dip there, but he's about the same every 5 times he carries the ball.
22 carries, 96 yards. Rodgers again. He did on the previous down get enough for the first down. Rams are saying he lost the football and that they've got it, but the officials don't necessarily agree. He got 3. Mark Giroux on the stop.
John Robinson there has done a heck of a job with this
really?
Ram team. He's been here 4 years, taking the Rams to the playoffs every year. And he said, what I want to do is not get where we're just a playoff team. I want to get to be a Super Bowl team, a team he called a lookout team. You know, no one ever says, look out for the Rams in the playoffs.
We don't want to go there. Look out.
It's like, look out for the Bears, look out for the Giants, look out. No one ever says, look out for the Rams. He said, that's the level he wants to get to.
Left side this time behind those backup individuals we were just talking about. Giroux was the first man to get there. We were talking to Coach Robinson yesterday and asking him if he started, when he started the year, there's Russ Grimm, said he had a possible cracked rib. Ask him if he felt at the beginning of the year that his team would again be in the playoffs. Only 2 other coaches, by the way, have ever done that. 4 years in a row, Chuck Knox and Paul Brown. And he said, yeah, I think if you told me I'd lose the players I lost and things would happen as they had, I'd be satisfied. Not without this victory, though. Schrader back in the pocket. Outside intended. Warren incomplete. And it'll will bring up a fourth.
Well, you know, the tough thing about the playoffs, Pat, is you start off the playoffs today, 10 teams are in it. 9 teams are going to lose their last game. And then that's the long off season. I think that's why the intensity level's so up. You know, there's a certain finality about playoffs. The winners go on, the losers have the rest of the year to think about it.
And you can feel, John, I know you'd agree, the level of intensity and competition go up. Cox, one off the side of his foot. Redskin bounce. At the 22. With 12 minutes and 9 seconds remaining in the season for one of these two, the Redskins lead 16-7.
Engineering and technology, unleashing a superbly equipped new breed of compact car, Dodge Shadow. With its 550 protection plan, 2 or 4 door availability, affordable price, the new Dodge Shadow is going to cast a giant shadow across America. Dodge, setting new standards of performance.
This bud's for all that you do.
It could be any time now.
No, Bill had to leave. Can I help you?
A friend is counting on you.
Need copies by 4:30.
I'll cover it for you.
Not a word.
You keep on coming through, cause you make America work, and this bud's for you.
Here's to you, Beechwood Age, for that clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser.
This bud's for you.
New Year's Day, don't forget, here on CBS, the Cotton Bowl, Dallas, Ohio State, the Buckeyes against the Aggies of Texas A&M, 1:30 Eastern Time. Right now we're at RFK Stadium, the nation's capital. Well, that's not RFK Stadium. Sales have been good, brisk.
I think that's the only guy that's down on the field. That guy's down there. Now, that customer there, he's trying to take all the pretzels. That guy's watching himself on TV, but he's on the field.
Another guy, the customer's going to go climb a building somewhere after the game is over. Eric Dickerson is the lone setback. And the handoff is to Dickerson, and there is nothing there. Calvin Daniels was the first Redskin defender.
Well, you know, Dickerson's the type of guy that you just keep pounding in there at him, and you hope that on one, like they did the last time, boom, that he'll break it through and get that big play for you.
Eric, number 29. Barry Redden now lines up to his right. He got a yard, and we'll make it 2nd and 9. Everett back to throw. Has some time and throws, almost has it picked off by Darrell Green. That ball slipped out of his hand. Kevin House, the intended receiver, and he and the Rams, Everett and the Rams, lucky that that one was not picked off.
Hey, you watch Everett now. Now he's looking at David Hill first in the middle. He was looking for David Hill. Slater runs man by. Now he has to turn. You see, but what he did is he was stepping forward like he was throwing in the middle, but he threw out to his right. So he really didn't have the power on it or the zip on it. The thing kind of died on him. It was almost intercepted.
3rd and 9. He operates out of the spread formation this time and has some time, and he's got some room to run. He should be able to get the first down, and does. To the 35, Curtis Jordan up in his face, but Everett, who's a big, good athlete, 6'5 and 212.
Watch him. He starts off here. They get a good block on man. You see, Slater gets man, who's the end man. He gets him to the inside. So when Everett goes back and there's nothing open, he has everything caved in to the inside. Watch it here, the left side of the screen. You see when 71 takes the inside, they collapse that whole side.
Dickerson to the left. Stopped by Milot, a gain of three.
I've always thought that a running back, a great running back, gets stronger as he goes. Here's Dickerson, his first five, second five, third five, look, and then the fourth. And you can see him going from 12 to 14 to 38 to 85. I've always felt that way about Eric Dickerson.
And all good running backs. Second and seven. Dickerson, the lone setback behind Everett. Redden in motion. Everett looking left. Pass complete. The defender, it was Henry Ellard. The defender never saw the ball coming.
That was Vernon Dean. It looked like Vernon Dean, number 32. Watch him on top of the screen. He gets turned around. He's facing that way, and look, he's still looking for the ball. Vernon Dean has yet to see it. It looks down. How did Henry Ellard get it? That's the first reception he's
right.
had today.
It is. And the Rams move into Redskin territory. Dickerson butts heads with Curtis Jordan. Pickup of two. Dickerson again well over that 100-yard figure. And a very durable individual. In fact, John Robinson said to us yesterday, we saw his most serious injury, which was to his toe. Clock running. 16-7, Redskins leading. Back to Dickerson again. And here he goes. Inside the 45, another gain of two. Bring up a third down situation, and they'll have to put it up again. Kelvin Bryant, who, as John Madden was pointing out earlier in the ballgame, suffered some bruised or broken ribs. They weren't sure in the game against Philadelphia last week, now having his pads worked on. Dickerson on the sideline, third and six. Darren Long and Barry Redden back with Everett in the spread, and again, looks out of the pocket to Long. It's going to be very, very close.
I'll tell you, it depends on how they mark this one. Although I'm sure with a score 16-7, the Rams are going to go for it anyway. But it looked like Long had the first down. Looked like he had possession of the ball beyond the first down marker.
Going to be fourth.
Well, I guess he didn't. Or they spotted it that way.
Here's an amazing thing about Dickerson, who's back in the game now. John Robinson said he won't take a tough hit if it means making a two-yard gain out of a one-yard gain. But if you need the first down, he'll punish you.
And this is a big, big need here.
Ball is loose again. Dickerson, I think, spun for the first down. Redskins are saying they have it.
Saying the ball is down. One official started to point that the Redskins had it. There's going to be a delay here.
The ball is ruled down. He did not make the first down.
He didn't make the first down.
He starts from the I formation real deep. Gets a good hit there. Spins off it. Is going down. You can see here's a marker right in front of us that he doesn't reach the marker. But you can see just as he goes down, the ball, just as his knee hits, the ball comes out. That's like the other one. That's academic. But I still wonder about the third down play.
Reviewed.
Aha.
The review would be here. If it's a fumble, it's a Redskins ball. If it's not a fumble, it's a Redskins ball.
I thought when he whirled, he had enough for the first down. Maybe he didn't. We'll have to wait and see.
was two marking plays there. Like the ball was loose before he went down.
Now who gets the ball?
I think they ruled that the Redskins recovered the ball. See if the ball is loose before he touched
it. It would have been Washington's first down either way.
That's what I thought. It's Washington's first down either way.
That's what they've ruled after review. And it's first down Redskins at their own 39-yard line. 8 minutes, 5 seconds left to play. Rodgers. That's Warren on the move. And the handoff, Rodgers. Not much there. One or two. But the clock continues to run. 16-7. Redskins over the Rams. Pat Summerall, John Madden at RFK Stadium. Rodgers now over 100 yards, 25 carries. Redskins have won 30 straight games when one of their runners has gotten over 100 yards. Second and eight. Rodgers with counter trade left. Ticks down.
You know, it's going to be an interesting thing if the Redskins win here and have to go into Chicago and play the Bears and not have Russ Grimm, who has a broken rib, who's down there in the sideline, not have Joe Jacoby, who has a broken hand, and then, of course, you look to one of the guys I think is the most valuable player in this team right here, Don Warren.
And it looks like he is suspect, and down he goes.
I think he is probably the most underrated player on this Redskin team.
He can do so many things. As Joe Gibbs says, he's like the 250-pound fullback playing tight end.
If we could get our orders
when
out...
When you talk with Hewlett-Packard about your networking problems, we listen.
Now, my people in the sales office over here can't communicate with the factory. I've already talked to four...
Because while we have all the hardware and software... We can't give you a networking solution if we do all the talking. So before we ask what if, we find out what's wrong.
We need to be cost effective. I have a suggestion. What if I took a look at your manufacturing floor? I could find out.
John Houseman for the investment firm of Smith Barney.
Nurturing today's tots, some may become tomorrow's tycoons. Smith Barney nurtures fledgling companies by helping to finance their growth. Like the company that makes this noisy little bear. It started small, it's now rather substantial. Smith Barney. They make money the old-fashioned way.
They earn.
You're going down a road behind the wheel of the new Dodge Dakota. The first true mid-size pickup ever made. With available 3.9-liter V6, room for three, and an optional 8-foot bed. The new mid-size Dakota. Climb aboard. Cross into Dakota territory. Dodge Dakota, the new state of the American truck.
Southwest Conference winner Texas A&M battles Big Ten co-champion Ohio State in the 51st annual Cotton Bowl Classic, New Year's Day on CBS Sports.
Stadium in Washington. The Redskins and the Rams, and the Redskins lead it 16-7. A wild card game. We're in the fourth quarter. Dickerson, three fumbles today. Rodgers, 103 yards rushing. And Jess Atkinson, three field goals. Donnie Warren over on the sideline, number 85, had his ankle taped, but he's out nevertheless. Third and eight, and Kelvin Bryant's in the game behind Schrader. Gray goes with it. Schrader back to throw. Up into the pocket. He's hard to sack. Taking his time, throws it away and throws it out of bounds. Bought as much as he could. Ran the clock down. out of 636 and stopped it with the incompletion. The Redskins will have to punt.
You know, I think the reason that Jay Schrader is sacked so few times is because he's so strong. You know, is you get him on a sack, you get him on a rush or a push, you get your hand on him, he doesn't go down. And he can move around a little, but he's a big, strong guy. And I think that's why he sacks so few times.
Plus, he's very fast.
That's probably the thing that people, don't think about. Yeah. How fast he is.
Cox gets off a good punt. Henry Ellard retreats, lets it bounce. And it dies right where it hits. At just about the 14-yard line. And the Rams will take it over. A punt of 43 yards by Steve Cox. NFC Divisional Playoffs next week on Saturday. The game will be at Soldier Field, Chicago. Either the Redskins or the 49ers against the Bears. And on a Sunday, it begins with the NFL today at noon. John Madden and I will be at Giants Stadium. For the Giants, we don't know who yet. Up the middle, and Kevin House is Everett, really. Threaded the needle that time between two Redskin defenders. Rams hurry up.
Of course, they have to hurry up because there's 6:06 left, and they have to think in terms of two scores.
Michael Young replaced House. He comes wide to the right. Ellard is split wide to the left. First and 10 Rams. They're behind 16-7. Everett. Pocket throws and the pass is picked off by Alvin Walton. Walton down the far sideline, and that should just about lock it up. Washington. Looks like the Redskins will go to Soldier Field with that interception. I'm not sure that he wasn't over the line of scrimmage when he let it go. It was close.
And we'll watch it again. He starts. It's not a rollout, it's a drop back pass. And he can't find anything. Pretty good protection. Steps up. And he was close to the line of scrimmage.
Very close.
He was trying to hit David Hill. And Walton had real good coverage on him.
Five turnovers by the Rams. None by the Redskins. Rodgers in the backfield. And Rodgers pounds to the 20. Owens on the stop.
There's Walton. You know, he's a real hitter. He's called the Crashing Kansan. So when he hits them, he knocks your cleats out of the ground. And then, of course, when guys hit, you know, they really like to get those interceptions, too.
The turnover ratio, 66 plus, 85 and 86 minus 10. A great concern to the Redskins, but today, that's done it for them. On second and five, it's Rodgers again. To the 21. Reggie Doss as the clock moves down. Timeouts remaining. The Rams have all of theirs. The Redskins have two. And they start that clock again. For George Rogers. Hail to the Redskins. They'll be singing again. Timeout, Redskins. Schrader, not sure. Strolls to the sideline. They have one left, but they have the lead.
Do you know me? I won the America's Cup. From me. I'll bet you Yanks can't even remember what it looks like.
They can't even remember what I look like. That's why I travel with the American Express card.
Likewise, mate. Without it, I'd be dead in the water.
What a pleasant thought.
To apply for the card, look for an application and take one.
The American Express card. Don't leave home without it.
Dust off your policy, dig up your bill.
Leave it to the good hands, people.
Do it right now or
into Allstate and compare our low homeowners rates. You might just save some money.
Check through your file. Look high and low. Get down to Allstate. You might save some dough.
Leave it to the good hands, people. You're in good hands with Allstate.
A member of the Sears Financial Network.
Gosh, Clark, we've got to get back to the office and call London before the meeting's over. Taxi!
AT&T card, your people have the power to handle business better.
Taxi, taxi!
From anywhere to anywhere.
Come on, Clark.
It's okay, Mo. Everything's taken care of.
You always disappear in an emergency.
Order the AT&T card. It gives your people enormous abilities.
Tonight on CBS starts with 60 Minutes, followed by Murder, She Wrote, starring Angela Lansbury. And that's followed by Outlaws and the premiere of a new series starring Rod Taylor and Richard Roundtree. All coming up tonight on CBS. Here at RFK, it's the Redskins 16, the Rams 7. Four and a half minutes remaining. Would appear that the Redskins will go to Soldier Field and the 49ers will play the Giants. Third and one. Rodgers gets the Redskin first down.
I'll tell you one thing, Pat. I've seen George Rodgers run in a lot of games for the New Orleans Saints and for the Washington Redskins, and I don't think I've ever seen him run as tough as he's running today. Of course, this isn't a good sign as we see him coming out here holding his left wrist. Because the Redskins have really been hurt today. They've already lost Jacoby. They've already lost Russ Grant. That's the left side of their offensive line. And now, if there's anything wrong, seriously wrong, with George Rodgers, that's a big part of their arsenal.
And don't forget that Donnie Warren and Terry Orr, although they're back in the game now, were shaken up early. They've only got a week to get ready. Rodgers, Mark Giroux on the stop. Washington injuries today, two of their most reliable and best. In fact, I think four of them, you could say. Or Warren, and the two at the top of the list, the left side of the offensive line. Rodgers in pain over on the sideline. It'll be second and six. Keith Griffin replaced Rodgers. He's the lone setback. That's Warren, who seems to be okay. On a move. This is Griffin. Right side, and he squirms down to what would be something close to a first down, about the five.
I'll tell you, I was just looking at that injury list, and you think of the Chicago Bears watching. You think of Richard Dent saying, what? Jacoby may not play. He has a broken hand. And Refrigerator saying, what? Russ Grimm may not play. Yeah, those guys will start bulking up back there.
The Refrigerator's going to start bulking up?
Well, he's done a good job. I mean, he's conditioned himself to about 350 pounds.
Been working on that a long time. Third and two. Griffin jumps inside the five, looks like he's got the first down. Mel Owens tripped him up. Clock stopped now at 2:19 remaining.
Well, the word on George Rodgers is that he has a bruised left shoulder and he could return.
He had a shoulder problem. Remember, he hurt it midway through the season, and there was some concern about that earlier. I thought it was his hand when he first came off.
Well, you know, it looks like, you see how he's shaking that thing, you know, and try and get the feeling. You know how you get hit up there in that bone and your whole arm goes numb? That's what looked like happened to him. And you're just trying to shake it back and get that feeling back in there.
2 minutes remaining. And it looks like the Redskins will advance and win the wild card game.
I need a trainer.
How about Eddie?
He's just a kid.
So was I.
You've worked long and hard to get there. When the time comes, you hope you're ready.
You make America work. This bug's for you.
Here's to you. Reach with age for that clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser.
This bug's for you.
Drive Dodge Lancer is the performance sedan that will thrill you all the way to the red line, hold you to the dotted line, cover you down the line, and impress you with its bottom line. Dodge Lancer, with prices starting at $98.52. Dodge, setting new standards of performance.
What if there was a new generation of business computing systems? Systems designed to take your company years into the future, to grow as you grow, to help you share more information, make better decisions, be more productive, competitive, successful. That system is here right now. The Personal Productivity Center from Hewlett-Packard. We never stop asking, what if?
His son, who will carry that helmet off when this game is over.
Yeah, I saw him at practice yesterday, and he had one of those remote control cars, and Dave, after practice, went out and is playing with his son, and his son was making the remote control car go, and when it would tip over, Big Dave would run over after the car, like 50 yards away, turn it back up, and his kid, the smart one, was running the remote control.
That helmet looks like it's been run over by a car. Player. Griffin hit down at about the two. It was first and goal. That'll make it second and goal. And Robinson and his Rams staff over to the sideline. Joe Gibbs. Remarkable job he's done here.
Well, you know what he said the other day? He said, you know, one of these teams will find all the answers in the game, and the other team will have their chin in the floor. And that's so right. He found the answers, and the Rams have their chin in the floor. You know, they lost to Miami, next week to the 49ers, and now in the wild card. That's an ending that lives with you for a year.
On second down, they give again to Griffin. And this time, he just barely gets back to the line of scrimmage before he's hit by Reggie Doss, Vince Newsom. The Rams take a timeout.
Here's what it looks like down there. Guys, Raleigh McKenzie, did you see him? He had a block Eckerd, number 55. He drives out. He can't get him, so he just grabs for him and still misses him. That's the stuff that happens down there in the pits at the end of the game. And the guys figure, what the heck? The game's over. We've won. They've lost.
But the competitive nature still remains. Charles Mann over on the sideline. It would seem that he might be injured now. Even though they advance, they will limp into Chicago.
I think, you know, they had a lot of flu going around. When we were in the locker room yesterday, Jay Schrader came out and said, don't go in there. Boy, that place is full of the flu.
You mean nobody tried to give it to you this week?
No, well, unless Schrader. I think he was protecting us. He said, don't do it. There's a lot of flu going on in that locker room. And that could be what man is suffering right now.
This telecast is presented by Authority of the National Football League. It's intended for the private use of our audience. Any rebroadcast or other use of this telecast without the express written consent of the Washington Redskins and the National Football League is prohibited. Kelvin Bryant now behind Schrader. Third down and goal from the five, and the give is to Bryant. And Bryant spins down close to the goal line. Forget 60 minutes. You've heard about it. Now let 60 minutes take you there, the Lord. The miracles take place at 60 minutes. Next, here on CBS. Timeout again, Rams. Fourth down at Atkinson back on the scene to attempt his fourth field goal. He's been successful from 25, 28, and 35.
This is a tough one for the Redskins here. You get down there, you really have the game. It's fourth down. You have to go for it somehow. So they decided, what the heck, we have a new field goal kicker. Today is the first time he's kicked a field goal for us this year, for anyone this year. Maybe we'll get him a little more practice in the playoffs. But I'll tell you, this win is really setting up two whoppers for next week. I think, you know, this team going to the Bears, I think that'll really be something. And then I think the one in Giants with the 49ers coming into New York, that's going to be a whopper.
That's the one we do next week at Giants Stadium. Don't forget the post-game show coming up next. Interviews from the locker room. And Jimmy the Greek previews the divisional playoffs. 16-7, Redskins leading, trying to make it 19-7 from 19 yards out. Atkinson is 3-for-3 so far. Schrader Hovick. Bang. 4-for-4. A minute left. 19-7, Redskins over the Rams.
Team that are just good enough to get there. They aren't good enough to win anything yet. But now with Jim Everett and having a quarterback, I think they're in the right direction.
That's the kind of day it's been for the Rams. The Redskins will be going to Chicago, and the 49ers will be going to Giants Stadium. Here's Everett outside to Dickerson. Flag down. Less than a minute left to play. Gordon McCarter, the referee. A couple of long reviews in the game, but nobody really protested, unless it was us.
Well, you know, the thing, I think that the Redskins...
Five, number 72 on the defense. Five-yard penalty, repeat first down.
The Redskins played almost a perfect game. They did offensively and defensively what they had to do. The Rams didn't. You know, they had the mistakes. They had the turnovers. They were fighting an uphill battle all day.
Everett back to throw, and he goes, picked off by Barry Wilburn. The intended receiver, midfield, and down he goes, and that should slam the final door. Six turnovers by the Rams, and you just can't do that. Three fumbles, four fumbles, and two interceptions.
Well, the Redskins know that that's the type of team they are, and I think that's why Joe Gibbs got mad last week in the locker room. I think that's what he's yelling, but you know, we're not good enough to give the ball. We have to take the ball away. We have to do those things. They did it today on the Rams side, they're saying the same thing, but they couldn't. They gave it up.
The Redskins now will just run it out. Clock shows 39 seconds remaining, and they'll take some more time off that. Chicago at Soldier Field to face the defending champion Bears. Sunday, the 49ers go to New York to face the Giants, and that'll do it. 19-7 as the clock runs down. Eric Dickerson, one big long shot. Dave Butts and his son. Coming up next, the NFL Today postgame show with Brent Musburger. Our New York studio, also Jimmy DeGreek, looks ahead to the divisional playoffs. And Irv Cross will be in the Redskin locker room and Will McDonough in the Ram locker room. You've been watching CBS Sports coverage of the National Football League.
Nobody has lower fares than you.
We listen to the radio and see.
It's Puttin' on the Hits, the show that makes you the star you always wanted to be. With our host, Alan Fawcett, and our celebrity judges, Anna Motion, LaToya Jackson, and Bob Zaney.
Look in the mirror.
Puttin' on the Hits is brought to you in part by Trident Gum. Taste the one that will win you over to sugarless gum. Now, here's the host of Puttin' on the Hits, Alan Fawcett.
And welcome once again to Puttin' on the Hits, where six talented lip sync acts from around the country will compete for $1,000 and a chance at our grand prize of $25,000. All of our contestants will receive complimentary gifts and a videotape of their performance. Judging our contest on originality, appearance, and lip sync is a panel of celebrity experts, and we'll be talking with them a little bit later on. But right now, let's watch a sales manager deliver his tribute to the Jesse Johnson Review. Here's Don Tanaka. Flipping over Jesse Johnson is Don Tanaka. How are you, Don?
Okay. Yeah.
Now, you're a sales manager, but you actually manage your own business.
Correct. It's a video, computer software, and records and tape store.
Very good. I'm going to tell you how you did with the judges, Don, but first of all, I'm going to explain to the folks at home the rules of our contest. And each of our judges will award up to 10 points in each of three categories, originality, appearance, and lip sync. Add each judge's score together in each category, and you come up with a combined possible total score of 30. In the event of a tie, our judges will make the final decision. Don, let's see how you did. Okay? Remember, the top score you can get in each category is 30. For originality, 25. For appearance, 28. And for lip sync, 25. Don Tanaka. Thank you, Don. Now let's meet our celebrity panel of judges. The lead vocals of our first pair of celebrity experts bring high energy and emotion to a band that has skyrocketed right to the top. From Animotion, please welcome Astrid Plain and Bill Wadhams. Astrid and Bill, welcome is in order for you being back in the United States now.
Thank you very much. We've been traveling all over England and Switzerland and Germany. And we're very excited about the fact that we went to number 2 all over Europe this year.
Very good. Ladies and gentlemen, from Animotion, Astrid Plain and Bill Wadhams. And our next judge has established herself as a successful actress and lovely fashion model. Ladies and gentlemen, say hello to Miss LaToya Jackson. Welcome, LaToya. And congratulations are in line for your new cosmetic line.
Yes, I am. Actually, I'm endorsing a cosmetic line as well as owner, so it keeps me quite busy. It's a complete skincare line.
And it's called?
Mahogany Image.
Very good. Ladies and gentlemen, the lovely LaToya Jackson. And the comedy of our third expert has been featured on radio, television, and in comedy clubs across America. With the Zany Report, here's Bob Zany. Welcome, Bob. Congratulations on your latest album.
Thank you very much. I'm just real excited about just having something.
What's the album called?
It's called Hi Home, I'm Honey.
Mm-hmm.
I knew they would get it, Alan. Look, Alan, look what I invented, the phoneless cord.
And I understand you're trying to grow something.
I've been trying... Well, thank you for pointing that out. Been trying to grow a mustache. What do you think?
Very good. Ladies and gentlemen, with the Zany Report, Bob Zany. And we'll be back with Actually Discovered at Six Flags Magic Mountain in Valencia, California, and the Eastland Center Mall in Detroit, Michigan, right after this.
Trident helps fight cavities, and it always has.
Helps fight cavities? Come on.
You mean I've been fighting cavities all this time without even knowing it?
I knew Trident didn't cause cavities, but help fight them.
Be great if it's true.
New dental studies prove chewing Trident after sugary snacks reduces acids that form on teeth. It's these acids that can cause cavities. Ask your dentist.
It's nice to hear a little good news once in a while.
Something that's delicious and good for you, too?
Why chew any other gum?
Trident, good to chew and fights cavities, too.
Hershey Bar, one of the old-time greats. When you want pure milk chocolate, with or without almonds, nothing but a Hershey bar will do. One of the old-time greats.
Happy birthday to you.
Our folks will be here soon.
And you're not ready. Spaghetti. Yuck.
This better work.
Listen to Sudsy Lemon. Use my Joy. We've got muscle. Look, on tough foods like this, Joy is the best cleaning lemon brand.
My dish is still dirty.
Joy Lift, it stays sparkling.
Look at this. You can see yourself.
Remember, of all lemon brands, Joy cleans best down to the shine. It's a nice reflection on you and me.
In the laboratory of Dr. Frankenstein, something incredible was created. The great taste of pure milk chocolate and delicious peanut butter. Unfortunately, no one would listen. And so the world would have to wait for the two great tastes that taste great together in Reese's Peanut Butter Cups.
And welcome back. When two young ladies put on the B-52s, they become the Bombers. The Bombers, and names behind the Bombers. Can I have your names, your ages, and what school you attend?
I'm Amy, and I'm 19. I'm a nursing student at Loma University.
I'm Jody, and I'm 17. I go to Lossier Academy.
And I'm Alan Fawcett. Let's go to the scores. Top score in each category is 30. For originality, 28. For appearance, 29. And for lipstick, 26. Thank you, Bombers. Okay. Now let's cross the stage and bring up the lights on the Fabulous Four. The Fabulous Four. Hello, gentlemen. Could I have your... Woo! My heavens. Have your names and ages, please.
Steve, 16.
Scott, 15.
John, 16.
Mike, 16.
And what school you all attend?
Brighton High School.
Where?
In Detroit.
And what station are your friends and neighbors watching you on in Detroit?
WKBD TV 50.
All right, gentlemen, let's go to the scores and find out how the Fabulous Four did. For originality, 26. For appearance, 28. And for lipstick, 26. Thank you, gentlemen. All right. Coming up, back-to-back acts from our official auditions in Salt Lake City, Utah, and Houston, Texas, right after this.
It's Pontiac's year-end blowout, and that's something special. Hot savings on these Pontiacs equipped with optional air conditioning. Pontiac's made it possible for us to pass along special savings of up to $675 on Sunbird or up to $775 on Fiero, Firebird, or Pontiac 6000, all equipped with air conditioning. You must take actual retail delivery from dealer stock by December 31st.
See your Pontiac pay centers now during Pontiac's year-end blowout.
The U.S. is a bargain if you know where to shop. And the best place is today's TWA. We've got low airfares to terrific cities all over the U.S. And TWA has great bargains on the ground, too. Like our Travel Value Pack. 48 pages of money-saving coupons for great deals on rental cars, restaurants, hotels, and much more in select cities. So call your travel agent or today's TWA.
Today's TWA.
Find out how good we really are.
The staff and management of WTAF-TV wish you and your family a happy and safe holiday season.
There will be no bombs dropped here.
In 1941, a few noble patriots decided to take the war into their own hands.
Lost. How many more like him do you think are up there?
John Belushi, Dan Aykroyd, and Robert Stack, 1941, Wednesday at 7:30 on TV 29.
And welcome back. Our official Salt Lake City auditions were recently held at the Crossroads Mall, and that's where we discovered the Flying Zucchini Brothers. Flying Zucchini Brothers. Gentlemen, could I have your first names and ages, please?
17, Mark.
Craig Singlin, 16.
Casey Loveland, 15.
Eric Steiner, 14.
Justin Brown, 16.
Breathing hard up here. And how'd you come to pick Mustafa?
Well, we like it because it's kind of a different thing from the ordinary song. It
certainly is. And what station are your friends in Salt Lake City watching you?
KSTU TV 20.
There you go. Let's go to the scores, gentlemen, and find out how you did. For Originality, 28. For Appearance, 29. For the Drink, 29. Nice job. And now, direct from our official auditions at the Town and Country Center in Houston, Texas, let's meet Holly Ritter.
Tender love.
Houston's very own Holly Ritter. How you doing, Holly?
We're doing great.
What are you doing, Houston, when you're not lip syncing?
I'm a school teacher.
Okay. Mm-hmm. What station are your students watching you on?
WTXH Channel 20.
Let's go to the scores, Holly, and see how you did. Tough score in each category is 30. For Originalia, 28. For Pyrex, a 28. And for lip sync, a 28. Thank you, Holly.
Thank you.
Okay. Two students salute Atlantic Star, and we'll salute last week's winner right after this.
It's a world of family ties, lots of fun, and homemade pies, and M&M's chocolate candies on mom's desserts. Kinfolk recall the old home place, and see the past in a brand new face. M&M's and family fun go hand in hand. All the world loves M&M's, pure milk chocolate joy for everyone.
M&M's chocolate candies, the milk chocolate melts in your mouth, not in your hand.
Hitting home runs is the fun part of my job. Catching is the tough part, the sweaty part. But you won't catch me showering with deodorant soap. I made a break from all that. A clean break with Ivory. Look, that's basic, natural, honest soap. Not like soaps that cover you with smelly perfumes or deodorant. What's that got to do with clean? Ivory's clean is an honest clean. You can smell it, you can feel it.
Make a clean break, because you just can't beat Ivory's Honest Clean.
Even when you got a special date.
Europe is a bargain if you know where to shop. TWA gives you a jolly good bargain to London. Paris, ah, what a bargain Paris is. Or the splendor of Rome for less than you dreamed. TWA is also a great deal to Munich. And Barcelona, the beauty of Spain for less. And Geneva is a terrific bargain, too. So call your travel agent for today's TWA.
Today's TWA.
Find Dad how good we really are.
Your favorite storyteller invites you to an enchanting show for the whole family. Walt Disney's World on Ice, starring Snow White and the Seven Dwarves. Just in time for the holidays, WTAF has a special gift for all Philadelphia children. Kids under 12 receive a $2 discount off the regular price of any ticket for selected performances at the Spectrum, courtesy of WTAF-TV, Channel 29. Share the delight and the wonder live in person. Walt Disney's World on Ice, starring Snow White and the Seven Dwarves.
Our next act discovered us on KTLA TV5 in Los Angeles, and we discovered them at the Plaza Pasadena in Pasadena, California. Let's meet the GQ Factor.
For the week of the week. She was wearing those red shoes. Everybody replied, she's hot. And as she moved to the rhythm of a beat, everybody fell apart. Oh. All of a sudden, she turned her head, eyes full of flame. I was hypnotized, mesmerized. I didn't even know her name. She
does the finest thing.
Factor, can I have your names, please?
Gerald.
And David.
And what do you do, Gerald?
I'm a baker.
David?
And I'm a waiter.
All right, you audition for us at the Plaza Pasadena in Pasadena, California. Let's see how the judges rated your performance. Originality, 28! For appearance, perfect score of 30. For the take, a 29. Nice job, gentlemen.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Now let's take a break from the action and look at last week's $5,000 semifinal winner, who is qualified for a chance at our $25,000 grand prize.
This is the time. This is the place. Your Quality Plus Ford dealer has the best-built American truck 6 years running and a great year-end deal. Get big savings on specially equipped full-size 4x4 pickups and great year-end deals on every 4x4 Bronco and Ranger in stock. Plus, December 31st could be the last time to take the full sales tax deduction on the purchase of your new Ford truck. So now is the time. Your Quality Plus Ford dealer is the place where the plus means year-end tax savings.
The thrills continue on The Next Lifestyles. The untamed animal instincts of Lauren Hutton and her dare-death life. From ghetto to solid golden, still in perfect harmony, The Temptations. Then Lifestyles' first living, moving swimsuit edition, set amongst the beauties of a mogul's dream paradise. Then it's Laugh a Minute on the Big Chill as Jonathan Winters goes north to Alaska. All on The Next Lifestyles. Don't miss it.
Tonight at 9 on TV 29.
Give blood through the Red Cross. You'll save lives, you'll feel great, and besides, you'll love the donut.
We've totaled up the scores, and it's almost time to announce this week's winner. But before we do, let's thank our celebrity judges from Andy Motion, Astrid Plain and Bill Wadhams, LaToya Jackson, and Bob Zaney. And here is this week's winner. Winning by 1 point. The 28 for originality, a 30 for appearance, and a 29 for lip sync as Atlantic star, the GQ Factor. Congratulations, gentlemen. Here's your check for $1,000. And you qualify to come back and compete in our semifinals, and you have a chance to win our $25,000 grand prize.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Come on in. I want to thank all of our wonderfully talented lip sync contestants. I'm Alan Fawcett. Join us next week as we continue making you the stars you've always wanted to be on Puttin' on the Hits. So long now.
If you'd like to compete on Puttin' on the Hits, call 818-843-POTH for Puttin' on the Hits.
Now's your chance to take it to the